All right. That was surprisingly pleasant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Connor O'Keefe. With me, as always, is Ethan Miles.
Wow.
And Guy Clark.
Where nothing about you, I touch you my way.
Good stuff. And we've got time to kill. Killing time with us this week is no one. It's just the three of us. Classic podcast. Classic time to kill.
All I heard was killing time with us. I'm like, what? What the fuck?
I just thought I'd chuck the N-word into conversation.
Yeah, maybe. Just like jump into it.
Yeah.
Straight up.
Speaking of jumping right into it, let's get right on the topics. Unless you guys have any...
Topics is the pet name I have for Ethan's asshole.
Oh, topics.
Because I have to apply all that topical hemorrhoid cream to it.
Yeah. No, it's tropical hemorrhoid cream.
What have you guys been up
to? It's a jungle.
Pineapple scented.
Have you guys been up to anything recently that you'd like to bring up before?
Well, me and Ethan were on... We were messing around last night. We were on this stream. I don't know if you know what a stream is.
That was my stream.
No, that Ethan and me make more than you, so what you say bounces off us and shut up.
Stream. So, stream is what it was called.
Stream is the exact name. We were streaming last night after hijacking Connor's stream.
Yeah.
So we did that. What were you editing on your stream?
I was editing a music video for Darcy
for
Fox.
Darcy
new,
Fox,
new
yeah.
Bullet for My Valentine.
It's close.
Yeah.
They sound the same.
Yeah, Darcy Fox is like,
no one cares.
I guess country pop kind of singer.
Is she an
songwriter?
Fox?
No.
Which is an offense because I'm fox kin.
Yeah,
you've lost all interest.
Well, she triggered me immediately. I stepped on the set. She wasn't a fox. I was like, ah.
So
whenever someone says they're triggered, by the way, I always imagine them like being like sleeper agents and like, activating and like trying to assassinate.
So this triggers me. I have to kill the president.
Yeah.
I got the giggles when I was tired and playing Pato.
Yeah.
Because it's always like the alarms have been triggered.
Alarmkin have been triggered.
Yeah. I was fast as alarm. Like, I identify as alarm and I have been triggered.
Can we talk about this? Yes, I was shooting shot a music video over the weekend with Darcy Fox. Which was real cool.
I was
editing that. It's a song called Options, and you can scope that out probably on SoundCloud.
Right, link in description.
Sure. If
pending release.
Patent pending. Yeah, so that was cool. And then I was doing streaming some editing because I bought a webcam finally. So
I didn't know you bought a new webcam.
So I can see to see. Because like up until recently, I'd been using my DSLR as a webcam, but that only works like 70% of the time. And the other, 30% of the time.
Yeah,
it works 70% of the time.
It's a good ratio.
Yeah. No, 30% of the time. The other 70% of the time, it would like not work, or I'd have to fuck around with it for ages to get it to work, and
it's supposed to be bad for your camera too. Yeah,
really.
I didn't hear that, but
it keeps
the
aperture open when it shouldn't be.
But it was fucking around. So I bought a relatively cheap webcam.
What quality is it?
It's apparently it's 720. It's 720p.
Why'd you bother? It's not 4K.
It's not. It's not super great. But
no,
the microphone.
It's not even regular great.
The microphone is surprisingly good. And up until recently, I've just been using my Guitar Hero microphone plugged into my computer, yeah, like permanently as a microphone. So this kind of gives me a decent microphone, better than the Guitar Hero mic, and a webcam. So that's cool. So I used that, did some streaming, which I think I'll do like pretty much like. Not all the time, but fairly regularly when I'm editing, because like editing gets kind of tedious on your own.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
But yeah,
get a second monitor, or just like a small ass one.
Yeah, it'd be nice to get a second monitor.
I got a second monitor.
I want to try and figure out how to get the screen sharing thing on YouTube to work, or just find a different website to stream on, because it'd
you
be cool
get it to work.
I could get it to work, but it wouldn't show like what I was actually editing on screen.
Yeah,
it would show just like a blank square.
Yeah, I think you may have to do full screen. Like,
yeah,
desktop,
I'll see how that
rather
works.
Than that, because
yeah,
I think it might be external from
yeah,
the program. So
yeah. Apparently, it was working for a little while, so I don't know. I'll see how it goes. Full screen, because like I was doing some special effects stuff, and our friend Wallace was watching, and he was like, "Oh, this is actually really cool. This would be like really useful if I could see what you were actually doing." And I was like, "Oh,
shit,
whoops." Yeah, there's a cat out there.
Was that Josh? Josh Wallace?
Yeah, Josh Wallace.
What's he up to?
I don't know. I didn't ask. We were in a stream. It was like...
Can you hear the cat?
Sorry. Yes, I can.
Kind of, but we won't be able to hear it on the mic.
Oh, okay.
So that was cool. And today, me and Ethan were shooting a new sketch for Harvey's Opera, which we've got a Facebook page up for that, by the way.
That took a while.
Curated mostly by someone other than us, which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
It's nice. Zach's sister, Andy, is like kind of curating the Facebook page.
Did you say his sister's name is Andy?
Yeah, A-N-D-I.
Never heard that before. Yeah. I've never heard that.
I, cool. When he wanted me to add her as admin for the page, he's like, oh, just search for Andy and then his surname. And I was like, oh, just trying to find her. I just can't find her. And it's like, oh, yeah, she got married, so she's got a different surname now.
Oh, that, yeah.
I guess about Zach that. Just forgot his sister was married for a while.
It happened.
And, yeah, so, excuse me.
Yeah, we got someone running social media for us.
Yeah, which is
all
cool.
60 of our likes.
But, yeah, that's it's, like, neat, look, like, seeing, I'll, like, check my phone, and it'll be like, oh, so-and-so, like, you know, liked the status posted by Harvey's Opera. I'm like, I had nothing to do with that. That's neat. It's nice getting likes on stuff that you didn't page. Realize existed.
Yeah. Well, it's where we put the official fan fiction.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah, we were shooting this guest today, and I got a couple of messages from other people wanting music videos. So that's cool.
Yeah, cool. Any work for nice. Me?
Well, like I said before, it's a bit weird. They asked me like what my rate is, what my going rate is, which I don't know what to say. And like
for you or Harvo's Opera?
For me.
Oh, cool.
Personal work, yeah. Which is cool. But they're like, what's your going rate? And I'm like, oh, shit, I don't really know. It's been a case-by-case basis kind of thing, which I haven't told them that yet. Mm. But Ethan's like, oh, can you get me some work? I'm like, it'd be weird being like, can I have this much money and can my friend have this much money also? He will do sound.
Well, that's why you just quote them all the money for you and you cut me in.
I cut you. What? Cut you in for what?
Sound.
On a music video.
On a music video.
Yeah, okay.
Writing, I could help you write it.
Yeah, well, I think they might just want a performance clip. I'll ask them and just say.
Oh
like,
God, no, I'm joking.
Oh,
if you wanted something like written, something like being writing on needed sound, then yeah. But just to like show up and be like, does anyone need anything from the shop? okay.
Yeah.
Is this food free or do we have to pay for it? Well, it's my like, mum's kitchen.
That's my lunch. It's in my lunchbox. It's got my name on it.
So no.
You say mid-mouth.
To see me slowly spit it back in.
Spitting the crisps back in.
Oh, man, speaking of which, where are the chips?
We don't have any chips.
Fries.
What? Oh, they're in the bag. I left them in the bag for you. Guy has chippies. Snack of the week. Guy has chippies, and we have Haribo Tangfastics.
I have Haribo Tangfastics.
I have eaten some of those Haribo Tangfastics, and I have water because I'm trying not to drink soft drink.
Yeah, me too. I just keep forgetting.
Earlier. Yeah, I had a Coke with the meal earlier. But it was like half ice. Fuck it.
Ice.
That was my first Coke in over a week. So
really
nice.
Yeah.
I had a Coke with lunch, and then I bought a Coke at 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
And then I had a Coke with dinner, and then I drank a Pepsi. So my whole like no soft drink kick isn't off to a great start.
Hey guys, what's your favorite animal at the zoo?
Ethan, that's us. He's talking to us.
Yeah.
Holy.
He said guys.
The Connor.
Guys, okay. Plural.
Guy Clark
plural,
and Guy Miles.
Yeah. Guy Miles.
What? Gunimals.
Guykin. Triggered.
I don't know. Did you see?
Did you see otters?
I quite enjoy the giraffes.
Yeah, you love your giraffes. What is it about giraffes that you
do? I don't know. They're
like
really
it when
stupid.
Hot
they
lie
are stupid.
Down next to the dead ones.
What?
Yeah. That was the thing that made me so like
horny,
fucking depressed. Like through Facebook, Ricky Gervais posted this picture of a woman that like shot a giraffe in Africa, and then posted a picture, a selfie on Facebook next to the corpse.
What a cunt.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. You know that there was that
she's
picture
like, oh,
of the,
well, it was old. And it's
there,
like,
there fuck was the
you.
Picture of that that woman who, like, shot a lion.
Yeah.
And held it up. And, like, that's kind of like that. That's absolutely, that's fucked up and stuff. But it's like, it's a lion. It's like king of the jungle. It's kind of, it feels like, hey, you shouldn't be doing that. But it feels like if it's like a, I don't know, worthy opponent or something. I don't know. It's still a fucking.
I don't think it's a worthy opponent. Shoot it from like a mile away with
a
rifle.
Yeah, that's true. With a sniper. If she, all right. If she attacked, if she like, yeah, had a knife fight with the fucking lion, then maybe. But it's still a dick thing to do. But a lion, you're like, well, that makes sense to hunt that for some kind of sick sport. But giraffe, what are you fucking kidding
me? If I killed a giraffe, I'd eat it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why?
Huh?
Oh, just because you do that, like you just eat
like,
what you kill.
Why is that bizarre to you?
No, I just don't know. I don't know. I've never, like, what do you think a giraffe's going to taste like?
Well, I kangaroo and kangaroo is good.
Giraffes. Never eaten kangaroo.
Yeah, giraffes are kind of like the kangaroo of horses.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess so.
Well, like if you hunt something, you're like, after fucking, it's either like a pest or you want to eat it.
Yeah.
If you're doing it for trophy, then it's like morally questionable. But like if it's anything else, it's like,
yeah. Yeah.
But she shot, like, and she said the giraffe was old, so it's like, so there was no challenge to it. You weren't shooting it for sport. You weren't shooting it for food. And you weren't shooting
it just
it
in
it was
Africa,
a pest.
Or was it in a paid sanctuary?
Don't know.
If it's in one of the paid sanctuaries, like those things are great for conservation.
Yeah, in a weird way. We watched that Louis Theroux doco about it. What's that called again?
African Safari, I think.
Yeah. That's if you like Louis Theroux docos, check that one out.
It doesn't. Cool. People that watch Louis Theroux documentaries are like, I find this too interesting.
If it's like,
I find this too painful to watch because Louis just keeps being like,
I want a blind man to do a documentary on a paint factory.
Louis Theroux's pretty bland.
He is. Have you seen him rap?
What do you mean by that?
How does that make you feel?
No, I thought you wanted a bland example of Louis Theroux.
A man in a paint factory is like, whoa. Yeah, Louis Theroux did a rap in one episode. It was amazing. It was
fucking horrible. It was painful.
It was like,
he did well, though.
As a bit of a rap kind of
Black
rap genius.
What was the thing?
Hip Hop and Porn.
What was the documentary? Was it Black Music, or was he in? I can't remember what it was.
No, it was just a documentary on Catholicism,
and he starts rapping.
Yeah, and he was
It was about rap music. Like, it was about like African American rap culture. Shit, I don't know.
I didn't say rap because that's really
racist. You said black.
Yeah, so black.
You straight up said black.
African black. It's like interchangeable terms. Like, did like a documentary.
Yeah, whatever. I don't give a shit. When's the last time you guys went to the zoo? Any kind of zoo?
God, no. 2-3 years ago. The Melbourne one. It's a nice zoo.
Yeah, it's nice.
I can't remember. Yeah. I know I went to
smells awful, though.
Hillsville Sanctuary.
It's because there's monkey shit everywhere.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I went to Hillsville Sanctuary. I'm part of my school, and I didn't really know anyone because I just went up there.
Yeah.
I'm bored and started feeding this bird that followed around with my mouth.
Wait, really?
Yeah, it was like, how? Had the really long ass curved.
You've not heard the story of how he met his first girlfriend?
No, it was
just
like,
how he followed
my
around.
Bird. Mama wants you to meet my bird. She's like, oh, you got a girlfriend. He's like,
I think it was like a caribou or something. Like, it just kept following us around for no reason. And this
is
thing
a caribou
is like,
a bird?
Is it? No, that's so. Maybe. Oh.
I think caribou are cattle.
No, I think caribou might be deer, but...
Who cares? Continue.
It sounds like caribou, and it's like a bird with a really long beak.
Yeah. Oh.
What?
Long beak. Yeah, caribou is like just like a moose.
What the fuck am I thinking of?
Canary?
No. Yeah, canary.
No, I know what you're thinking of.
Yeah, it like had a really long beak and was following us around, and I was eating chips. No. Like a long, narrow, curved beak.
Yeah.
Stalk?
Like, no, like my dick.
No, like a kiwi bird.
Oh, like kiwi birds don't have long beaks.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, like a kiwi bird, but on a giant scale. Anyway,
kiwi...
it kept following us around, so I like put a chip in my mouth.
Compared to the body, no.
Yeah, I like put a chip in my mouth and leaned over to it and it freaked out, and it was like kept moving closer. I'm like, come on, get it. You'll get it. Oh, mouth fed a bird because I was bored. It was a good day.
That's not how you're supposed to chew it up and then like pry their mouth open and
vomit.
Spit it in. Yeah.
No, I meant to vomit on the bird.
Society Twitter and projectile vomiting on the bird. Zookeepers are trying to catch it.
Hand me that bird. Next. It's like the oil cleaning programs, the opposite. They hand me clean birds, not vomit on them. And they pass me the fresh one.
They clean the oil off the birds, hand them to you, and you vomit more oil onto them.
Their mothers won't love them unless they smell of vomit.
Yeah, they need to not smell like the oil. I'll cover them in vomit.
That thing's not true, by the way.
What isn't?
Well, like if you see a baby bird and you pick it up, the mother won't love it anymore.
Really? Not true?
That's entirely bullshit.
How'd they find that out?
The girlfriend won't love it because it's seeing it with another man.
Yeah. But apparently mother birds aren't so stupid that they'd abandon their own child because it smells like a human.
You were going to say smells like a man.
Smells like a man. What is that? Is that Lynx deodorant you got there? Is that Lynx Africa?
Is that Axe body spray? Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, you spray it, rub steak on it. You put some rum on it, put it back
in
the
man,
nest.
You're a man now.
Put some rum on it, put it back in the nest. Where have you been? Oh, I fell out of the nest. Oh, I'm sure you didn't rum
I can smell it on
you. No, it's like, where have you been, baby bird? Ow. God,
mom.
I went to the zoo.
Why'd you put a mark there?
I didn't put a mark. I just adjusted the audio because it was peaking a little bit. I went to the Melbourne Zoo recently with Caitlin, and it was cool. Bunch of my favorite animals at the zoo are the monkeys. Yeah. And the chimpanzees.
We didn't say what our favorite
orangutans
animals were.
I don't like looking at the primates. I feel like they're too smart.
The orangutans look awesome. But when they're sitting there and you can see, like, sadness in their faces, it's kind of sad.
Yeah, give them a fucking Nintendo 64 shit.
Yeah.
give them Donkey Kong to play.
Have you seen that video of the, like...
leader of the bunch.
I think it's a baboon or some kind of fucking monkey. Is like, a dude stands with his back to the enclosure.
Yeah.
And the monkey just gets fucking angry
and,
like, swings around
on the rope
and, like, swings
it.
Himself as hard as he can at the glass. That was cool.
Could you do that?
No, I couldn't.
I don't have a tail. I could do that.
I was like, me and Caitlin like get to this. It was the orangutan enclosure.
I was not invited.
And apparently they're not monkeys, huh?
Well, I was not invited.
Because it was like a date. Fucking third wheeling.
Me and Guy could have come.
Yeah.
We like monkeys.
Double date.
We like dates.
No, because then I'd end up paying more attention to you guys, and Kayla would get jealous.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. that happens already.
She get jealous of like the monkeys okay, you're paying attention
real quick,
to.
Real quick, here's a story. Caitlin won't mind me telling this.
You're
one.
Already telling a story.
Yeah. No,
I like you said that, implying that she hates every story you've told.
So when over Christmas,
oh, so stupid Caitlin was doing something.
What's my woman like?
Caitlin won't mind this one. So me and Caitlin are having greasy, smelly sex.
Well. Oh.
And then midway, I shit my pants.
Making it greasier and
smellier. I shit her pants.
Stop mocking it.
So over Christmas, I was at Caitlin's in Traralgon, visiting like her mum's house.
Again, why didn't you invite me?
well, Guy was in Traralgon at the same time.
Yeah, you didn't get invited.
And we were gonna go for a walk in this like national park near Traralgon that's like really nice and stuff.
It was actually national.
And she's like, oh, I'll see if you know if Nan and Mum want to come and we'll make a day of it. I'm like, yeah, that sounds great. And she was like, all right, Mum's the next day, like we're getting ready to go. And she's like, all right, Mum's too tired from work, so she's not going to come. I'll just give Nan a ring. Gives Nan a ring. Nan's not feeling up to it. And she's like, okay, so she's like, that's okay. All right, bye. Hangs up. And she's like, okay, so Mum doesn't want to go. And yeah, Nan's not that keen. I'm like, oh, do you want to give Guy a buzz? And she just looks at me. She's like, really? I'm like, what? And she's like, you want to invite Guy on our date? I'm like,
because it's less weird to invite Guy than her mum and her grandma.
Well, no, I was like with the mum and the grandma.
She kissed the mum and grandma because it's like the same person.
With the mum and the grandma, I thought she just wanted to have other people there other than me. I thought she just didn't want it to be like just the two of us walking around in the forest because, I get angry. No, that's putting a marker there.
No.
I get angry around trees. Someone said he gets angry.
I don't get angry.
you get mad.
But yeah, she was
I don't
like,
get angry, I get even.
She's like, are you fucking kidding me? And I was like, oh no, that was a joke. And she's like, no, it wasn't. You legitimately wanted to invite your fucking boyfriend on this date.
Oh, and that's how you ended up going to a national park with Guy and without Caitlin.
To be fair, my ex used to get really angry that you were around all the time.
Me?
Well, like, wait, friends in general.
I used to bring candy and shit around.
Yeah.
Because I felt bad.
We never got
time alone.
Like this.
And
because I always invited my friends.
Also, fuck her. I've been friends with you more than she has.
Remember when you and someone went debutante dress shopping,
and we brought you. Yeah,
brought me along.
Who was this?
We're like, oh, probably gonna go look for dresses up at High Point.
Yeah,
and I was like, oh, cool. I was like, do you want to come? We can go to Game Traders.
Oh my god,
I'm bad at doing.
Game Traders.
I do that. What
was that while dating or the person you were doing deb with?
I mean, no. Like, I wasn't doing deb with this person, but like we were dating.
Oh, okay, yeah.
But yeah. I do that without even realizing I'm doing it. I just think of it as like a, hey, fucking the more the merrier.
Yeah.
But yeah.
More people shopping for debutante dresses, the merrier.
Yeah. So yeah. And I've done that a couple of times since,
that's
I think.
That's really funny.
Completely by accident.
No, that's real. But I like we're on the same page because both of our partners have been like, why the fuck is he always here? Carter.
I just like that she was like, we're not inviting your fucking boyfriend on our date.
It's fantastic.
Yeah,
that ruined a friendship with me and someone else because they jokingly said like, "Why do you keep talking about Connor?" Oh, like, oh, you and Connor are gay.
Oh,
and
I got really mad.
Yeah, I got really pissed off. It was like, I'm going to get fucking the party van on your house and shit.
Jesus,
this
Christ.
Was like teenage angst. I'm like, don't talk shit about Connor.
Wait, who was this?
You don't know. I'm the Interalgon. Yeah. It was like the first year I moved
there. Interalgon.
Yeah, a friend basically like got really mad and ended up like yelling at this person over MSN.
Yeah.
She said I was gay for a guy.
Yeah. I got mad. I was like, because gay back then was a slur. It wasn't a thing. People weren't gay.
Gay wasn't invented till late to the mid 2000s.
No, it really wasn't. Like,
it was created by the
only
Jews.
The year or two after that, I actually met gay people. I honestly thought they were like a joke because, like, on The Simpsons and shit, they always like joked about like hint people were gay, but I never knew anyone that was gay. Even now, down here, I don't really know any gay people that were, like, from our school or whatever.
Oh, I know a couple that came out as gay almost immediately
Ethan
after
is now pointing
school.
At God.
Stop pointing at me. I have a beard. Girlfriend. no, like...
Cum stash.
A couple of...
Guy made... Sorry, just because you were saying beard, girlfriend. Guy made the most perfect, like, wordplay joke the other day that he didn't get himself.
Oh, my God.
What?
We were in the Hungry Jack's parking lot, and he kept missing the drive-thru, and he almost drove...
No, I got that one. I said that on purpose.
He almost drove into the bollards, and we're like, whoa, Jesus Christ. He's like, what? It's Hitler's birthday. I can hit some poles if I want to.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Everyone laughed. No, I did know what I was making then.
That's funny. Sure. Sorry, back to the zoo story. So, yeah, we get to the orangutan, like, exhibit, and I'm like, ah, yeah, sick. And I come up, I'm like, ah, cool, monkeys. And Caitlin's
then a bunch of African men in front of you turn around so angrily.
Caitlin's like, yeah, good for you, dear. You like the monkeys. And then this little girl with her mum, like about 3 feet in front of us, goes, look, mum, monkeys. The mum's like, they're not monkeys, they're primates.
Yeah.
And like Caitlin looks at me and I'm just like kind of looking like, fucking bitch, I'll push you into the monkey cage.
The monkey cage. Yeah. You're like pushing over there. She's like, good luck.
Shit about the monkeys. Apparently they're not monkeys unless they have tails.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, that's why Diddy. Yeah, that's why Diddy.
You're a foxkin.
That's why Diddy's a monkey and Donkey's not.
That's
the army comes.
One thing that was nice about the zoo and like about the city in general, I guess. But the zoo was really cool because it's like it got a real family vibe.
Because there were monkeys.
Make you want to start your own family?
No, not at all. No, kids terrify me. But seeing like people of every like race, religion, fucking
Connor, those are animals in the zoo, all not people.
Tails, no tails, four legs, two legs.
There were these dudes with huge necks and dots all over them. I said, hey,
the leopards.
They didn't talk back. The strong silent type. No, but like there's just like people of all different descriptions there.
Flavors.
All like. Even if they see someone and they're like, I hate you, they're keeping it to themselves because we don't want to do it in front of the monkeys.
I mean, I see people of every type just at the station.
Mm. Yeah, but that's what I mean. Like, even in the city, it's nice. Like, just walking around and seeing people kind of not even getting along, just tolerating one another because fuck it.
Just tolerating,
Like, for the most part, nobody wants to ruin anyone's day. But, like, at the zoo, there was, like, I didn't know that we had much of a Jewish community in Melbourne. Like, I didn't realize that was a thing.
How would you say?
What? How would I know? But like, I occasionally see some. I've maybe seen like three or four like people wearing the yarmulkes and stuff, or have the like big hats with the curly hair. In the city, and
Ethan is like,
as me and Caitlin were coming
really
around,
face palming.
Yeah, he's scratching his head. He thinks he's proud of me. As we're coming around the corner to the hyena exhibit,
your foreskin off in respect. Of their culture, and then threw it on the ground, stepped on it, and yelled "Mazel Tov."
That's what they do at Greek weddings. So we got around the corner, and there was this class full of. There was like, because it was the school holidays, it must have been like a Jewish school or something. It was like a bunch of Jewish elder dudes and a bunch of little Jewish kids, and they were all like the real like devout like. I don't know what Hasidic Jews with the curly hair and hats. Hasidic Jews, they were just burning through the ground.
Yeah.
And I came around the corner and I was so like excited to see like a big group of Jewish people that I almost managed to catch myself as I was about to do it, but I came around the corner and almost went, oh, Jews! And I kind of went, oh, and Caitlin like looked at me and she's like, oh, you like hyenas? I'm like, yeah. And then we got around the corner.
Don't call them that.
We got around the corner.
And you let it all out. You just went,
I explained what had happened. And she's like, you're a fucking idiot. And I hate
she every, to deal with you.
Both of the stories you've told
and with
your girlfriend.
Her being like, you're
that.
A fucking idiot. Yeah.
Let's tell more stories about how we annoy Caitlin by existing.
I apparently get a very like special kind of like childish glee out of saying
from
shit
Jews.
Out of saying shit that I know she's gonna like just kind of furrow
so
her brow
good.
At.
She loves it when you do it as well. Yeah. Otherwise, we wouldn't keep doing.
No, it's endearing.
Yeah.
You guys got any stories about the zoo?
Zoo
stories.
Fucking
tell a zoo story.
You know the saddest thing that ever happened to me?
Oh shit, yeah.
What? You didn't
go to
the zoo?
The saddest thing. I was like itching my eye when I did that, so it looked like I was holding back tears. When I went to the
physically
zoo,
holding them back.
I think it was the London Zoo with my mum once.
No,
like, it was a big trip. And I got to go see the giraffes, and like they did the feeding time at the zoo.
Yeah.
And they picked the kid next to me to feed a sandwich to a giraffe.
Sandwich.
Like, I was mad about drafting. That would have, like, I would have just been like, all right, cool, I can die now. Mom, Dad, I'll see you in traffic.
Well, no, you would
see you in Valhalla.
No, I'll
you
wouldn't see you in hell.
No, you wouldn't do that. You'd be like, I can die now. So you just held on to the sandwich. And the giraffe's like a snake.
Yeah. You see me going down its neck.
Yeah. Why did you make a staircase motion for its neck?
Do they have the same amount of bones in their necks as we do?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's fucked up.
Uh-huh.
Another zoo.
Fact.
But not actually a zoo.
Is that fact?
Connor's house.
This is a terrible segue. Weddings. What do you guys think of weddings?
Well, I'm not married.
You want to do that segue?
No.
Speaking of expensive, pointless events.
Speaking of filthy animals.
Speaking of Brandon yelling upstairs. Speaking of lifelong entrapment in a small cage.
Created by man.
Yeah.
Yes.
Created by man and
weddings.
The Christian church.
Marriage wasn't created by the Christian church.
Yeah, it was.
White people. White privilege.
Yeah, otherwise.
White privilege is what made zoos. You go in there and I don't know. Anyway, it was really.
Look at those filthy orange cats.
Ethan's not bitter. We went to a wedding for a couple of friends, Roberts and Kiara.
Both
are now Crosdale, yeah.
Yeah, rest in each other's lives.
Yeah. But yeah, we went to a wedding. Usually, I mean, I don't get weddings.
I'm just going to play Angry Birds for this.
Usually he doesn't cry for weddings, but
no,
this time he
this
also
one.
Didn't cry.
I
kept with him not usually crying.
I don't get weddings and I don't usually like
them
very much. But yeah, but like this, it was nice seeing the two friends very happy.
Yeah,
I think the problem with the weddings I've been to previously is either I've been filming them, so I haven't known the people, or they've been family. I haven't liked them that much.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Like
so it was nice seeing them happy. Guy, you made a speech.
The real speech of the night.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Guy, you're going to have to explain this. And Ethan, you're going to want to pay attention for this.
Sorry, I'm on level two, so.
Put your Angry Birds down.
That's yeah, go play Birds. Smash like a real man.
No,
don't play any of that
down.
Casual bullshit.
Okay, tell me about wedding.
Okay, when a man and a woman hate each other very much, but separating is financially unstable.
Yeah.
They get married.
Yeah.
Oh. But
you get tax benefits. I
yeah,
think.
Tax benefits.
Benefits.
You get obese off them. Okay, so at the wedding, me and everyone were there. We did speeches. I did a speech, not really worth noting. It is because I yelled at Mikey and it was funny. Mikey got drunk and annoyed.
He was incredibly drunk.
It was fantastic.
He kept you guy made a speech and during this and it was a good speech. It was just him like talking shit and it was funny. But during his speech, because Mikey was really drunk, he kept trying to like talk to the person next to him.
Oh, no, he wasn't by that point. He sobered up. But
no, we hadn't. Let me finish this.
When I say sobered up, I mean he wasn't completely fucked.
Okay.
He was regular.
He was like trying to like talk or something to the person next to him, and Guy just kept turning around and screaming, "Shut up!" Like out of the mic, but so the whole room could hear him, which was really funny. And
you know
Mikey would like nearly cry laughing.
You know what the best part was? When he was talking, he was saying, "I hope he doesn't mention me." That's what he said for all like two or three times I yelled at him. He was like, "I hope he doesn't do anything."
He made a fucking He made a habit of saying like the same thing over and over again. Cause he came up to me four separate times and came up to me and goes, "Oh man, did you see what happened with Guy's speech?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I was watching." Yeah. I'm like, and he's like, "Did you see?" And I'm like, "I think I did." And he's like, "Oh, okay, mate." And starts telling me, he's like, "Oh, I was trying to talk. I was trying to say something, and he just kept yelling at me. And I was like, yeah, no, I saw it. It was funny.
Everyone in the entire room saw.
Yeah, I was talking to you about this earlier, and he's like, oh, man, walks off. And then, like, 5-10 minutes later, he comes back and has the same fucking conversation with me.
Yes.
And I was like, he was really drunk, so I didn't want to be like, shut up, Mikey. But
I did that enough.
Yeah, he did that enough.
But he didn't say anything. He didn't have a speech. He didn't have
basically.
A speech, to which afterwards I said with a group of friends, "Great speech, Mikey." To which everyone said, Mikey, great speech. So then Mikey's like, "Well, I didn't have a speech," and then went off, and then more and more people got told about Mikey's speech.
Yeah, Guy basically ran around the wedding like a madman telling everyone, "Hey, if you see this kid Mikey,
before that.
What?
They were talking and he kept saying, "I don't have a speech." To which Jake replied, "That part about the bike was great."
Yeah.
Jake didn't know it, but Mikey and Rob have a bike story. So Mikey freaked the shit out, mentioned it. I got Rob to debrief the immediate friend group on what the bike story was.
Yeah. So everybody knew what was going on.
Yeah, so there were fact checkers.
Yeah, and so...
And then I went around the entire place telling absolutely everyone, the father-in-law, like everyone.
And this is even
to
better.
The point where his
Mikey,
parents...
Well, so the thing is, Mikey came out after a while.
Mikey
he came out.
Out.
No, he came out of the building
that was
with a smug look on his face.
Yeah.
And we're like, oh, it's,
he
dude,
was so pleased.
We're just talking about your bike speech. And he's like, I didn't make a speech. I asked my mum, and she said I didn't make a speech.
He had to get his mum to verify. Yeah.
And then the guy runs back in and tells his parents, hey, if you see Mikey, tell him he did make a speech, okay? Just we're fucking with him.
His dad likes to fuck with people as much as Mikey.
And
possibly
so,
as much as me. So when I'm explaining it to his parents, I go up, I crouch in between them and go, oh, gee, how good was Mikey's speech? They both look at me like, what? I'm like, your son, great speech maker, made the best speech. His dad has already started smirking in his hand violently. And his mum's like, what speech am I? It was a great speech, but everyone should just congratulate him for it.
Yeah.
If you see him, congratulate him because he deserves it. But the bike part was the best. His dad is in tears just sitting in the chair because he knows exactly what's going on.
And Mikey comes back out. And he says, it's my boots or whatever. Guy goes back in, does his thing. And then about 10 minutes later,
his dad flashed.
Mikey, his dad comes out. And
his dad
with Mikey.
His dad comes out of the building, and we're all standing there, and his dad's just coming out to have a smoke or whatever. And we're still going on about the speech, and he sees his dad. He's like, Dad, I didn't make a speech, did I? You said before. And he's like, no, you made a speech. It was great. And Mikey's just like, no. And then
is that a tantrum?
Yeah.
And then
he storms back into the building. And then about 10, I'm like pissing myself and telling strangers hey, if you see this Mikey kid, tell him you did a great speech. And guys running around literally, I've never seen you in such hysterics.
Bullying people is great.
Bullying Mikey is great, apparently. Oh. And then he comes out and I hear, where's Guy?
Yeah.
And I look over and Mikey's just looking around kind of laughing but also scared for his life. He's in a fucking David Fincher film. And he's like, where's Guy? And I'm like, he's over there and he finds Guy. He's like, Guy, I just sat down with my mother who has never lied to me in my life. I sit down, I pour myself a drink as taking a sip.
He says, he walked over to his mum and he asked his mum, oh, is that dad's drink? And she said, yes. So I drank it.
As I'm drinking it, she says, well done on the speech. The bike part was the best bit. And guys just nearly suffocating with laughter at this point. So he finds, we've told everyone at this point, everybody's in on the joke.
I think one
and
of the best
celebrant,
we got.
The celebrant comes out.
He
starts yelling to the celebrant,
you, I didn't make a speech, yes. I didn't make a speech.
And I'm grabbing him, Mikey, leave the man alone, leave the nice man be. And what were you going to say, guy?
Oh, no, it was after that part.
Okay, so he's like, leave the nice man be. And I'm like, leave the man alone. And the celebrant's like, oh, yeah, I think I remember her. But he was kind of a bit of a square or whatever. So he's like, oh, I can't lie. No, you didn't make a speech. And we're all just like, ah, bullshit. And we're like, he's crazy. You don't know what he's doing. You made a great speech, Mikey. Don't let him bring you down. And then it gets to the end of the night.
No, you yelled and you were laughing so hard because Mikey was the proudest fucking motherfucker in existence.
Oh, when the guy clarified that.
Yeah,
he did
and
not
you
make
said, why do you trust this complete stranger over both of your parents?
Yeah,
we're just everyone is just laughing at him.
Yeah.
One of the best parts was I got Alvin, who's Kiara's dad.
Yeah.
Who's this big, humble guy, doesn't say much, is always nice. Mm-hmm. You know who Mikey is.
You got him in on savage bullying.
Mikey's where's Guy? And he walks up to me. As he walks up to me, Alvin walks past me and goes, oh, great speech, Mikey. And Mikey's what? Alvin never says anything.
And then it gets to the end of the night.
No, before that as well, one of the other good parts was Robert's mom, Cindy. She's always been an auntie to Mikey because they've known each other since kids.
Yeah.
I see David, Rob's dad, walk out. I was like, David's like, yeah, have you seen Mikey? No, have you heard about Mikey? He's like, what? I'm like, oh, if you see Mikey next. And then one of you was like, Mikey's coming. Oh, don't worry. So I walk back. Mikey walks out with Cindy in tow. David says, hey, Mikey. He's like, what? And points at me. He goes, he was going to say something about you. Mikey looks at me and Cindy walks up to me with one of those over the top, complete, what have you done? Looks like angry mother. And Mikey's like, get him, Cindy.
Get him, Mikey. Oh.
Yeah, I laughed so hard that I told them, and they like told Mikey as well, like, oh, great speech. Like, he had no safety blanket.
Well, his safety blanket was the celebrant.
Yes.
And at the end of the night, the celebrant's like saying like he's, you know, his final thing. He's like, okay, you know, they're gonna do the thing where they stand, everyone stands in a circle, they say goodbye and all that. Yeah. All right, off they go. All right. You know, thanks everyone for coming out and celebrating this wonderful day with Robert and Kiara.
And the very last thing he says at, like, the end of the night.
Can we get a big round of applause for Michael? What a great speech. I look over and he's just like,
Brad grabbed his hand and held it up, and everyone applauded.
Scowling, and he's got this room full of people applauding him for a speech he never made.
That's so great. Then, like, as he's walking out, he just like mutters in the mic, that part about the bike was great.
Yeah. And so I went up to, like, as I had to leave pretty much straight away after that, and I went up to him. I was like shaking everyone's hand, saying, you know, goodbye, hugs, and all that.
Yeah.
And then I get to Mikey, and I'm like, all right, see you, dude. And he's just like looking at me, and he will not touch me. Yes. I'm just like, ah, oh, hugs for
so
you.
Bad.
He was like, he was smiling, but he was so frustrated.
It was
amazing.
I spoke to the celebrant as everyone's walking around. I'm like, I will give you $10 to say this. Like,
yeah,
no, I'll just do it, lady. Want to take the money? It made me laugh so fucking hard.
That's amazing.
Like, oh my god.
So that was like, so I mean, happiest day of Robin's Kiara's wedding. Yep. Happiest day of our wedding lives.
What did Rob and Kiara think of Mikey being the centerpiece of their wedding?
They seemed okay with it. I don't know about Kiara. Kiara didn't say anything.
Rob found it funny as hell.
Yeah, Rob got the giggles because they're like best friends since childhood and shit.
I'm sure Kiara saw the funny side of it.
Oh shit.
Yeah. You know what? Sorry, I'm going to call you out on this, Rob and Kiara. You sent out on the invitations, you said song requests, and I asked, are the songs going to be played no matter what? And you were like, yes, I give you my solemn vow.
Solemn vow.
Yeah,
solemn vow.
We made a blood oath.
They cut their
hands. Cut my hands and rubbed it on my dick.
And ate their hands.
their hands. No, they were like, yeah, it'll be good. And I'm like, okay, so I requested Through the Fire and Flames by Dragon Force to play at their wedding because I'm a fucking romantic.
Yeah.
And not only did that not play, I don't think any of the requests
I was going to say that, but we weren't in there the entire time.
No,
so
I was
I'll
listening.
Give them the benefit
no,
of
no,
that.
No, I was listening out. No Dragon Force. Lachlan requested Paramore. No Paramore.
Really? What did he request?
That seems acceptable.
I'm still into you.
Yeah, that's a good. That's a
weird wedding song, though.
Yeah, right?
Well, there
despite
have been
knowing you for 5 years, I still love you.
But at one point, like, I'm not legit mad about that, but on the night I was just like, ah, bullshit, I wanted to hear Dragon Force playing at a wedding.
Yeah.
Dragon Force wasn't there, Paramore wasn't there, I wasn't there.
Yeah.
I didn't have a song request, and I found out the week before that they're like, I was like, oh shit, you're like taking heavy songs. They're like, yeah.
Yeah. But they didn't play any heavy shit. So
yeah,
like maybe like I think they probably like the DJ they hired or whatever was probably just like, oh whatever,
fucking
I'm just gonna play this shit. But as we're walking at one point, Kiara and some of the like bridal party and like some people I didn't know from Kiara's side of the wedding were standing outside the room thing. And
the
I was
room
I
thing.
The building the wedding was being held in. We were in like the garden area.
I
walked back into the doorway just to hear what was playing, just to see if it was Dragon Force or anything, you know, that I wouldn't mind listening to. And it was some kind of funky disco shit. And so I've walked past them and then heard that and turned around and really like louder than I thought I was. Gone. I've heard that and gone, ugh. And like turned around and I've like said it as I'm looking at the bride and her friends. And they all just kind of looked at me. I'm like, oh, not you. You guys are great. I'm sorry.
I kept pulling faces at the bridal party when they were like getting married, like signing the forms and shit.
Yeah.
Because like they're trying to hold back tears and shit.
Get.
So they kept holding back tears. I just keep looking at them like with stupid faces. So they'd be like,
they accidentally spell the name wrong on like the marriage certificate.
Rob writes guy's name like Kiara should be.
Kiara also writes guy's name.
You marry yourself that day.
Yeah. Happiest day.
I've never been to a wedding, but I've been to like a school disco.
Yeah, you ate chips. You spent all your money
on
chips.
My mom gave me like £5.
As we've discussed,
so
that was the selling point.
Yeah, I had to go with some
girl. That's the selling point for any event for Ethan. Will there be Christmas?
Oh, man.
It was so good. It was just like a box full of crisps. Honestly, I think I took like 3 bags and was like, here's money for one, and they didn't care.
Oh, another thing. This is a thing that I saw at the wedding. Don't know who it was. I hope I don't offend Rob and Kiara. All the people at your wedding were lovely.
Except this one.
But this guy had a look that I don't get.
Kinda.
Popped collar.
Yeah.
Pink polo shirt.
Yeah, I've seen that
collar,
look. I've seen that look.
And sunnies on the head. And too much gel in his hair.
At a wedding.
Yeah, wow. And I'm pretty sure he had golden tips.
Man, I always like to tell people that collars are up. Up when they come into work like that.
Yeah, because that's not a good look.
And then they have to explain that, no, I want it to
Yeah,
be up.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I think this looks good.
Yeah. And he was just every time I looked at him, I was still up.
Maybe he got caught and a tragic industrial vacuum accident.
Yeah.
Everything from his neck upwards has been sucked upwards.
Even his eyes, and that's where he wears his sunnies.
Yeah, his eyes look directly upwards. He wears his sunglasses on his forehead. Yeah, exactly. That's where he feels the vision is.
Wow, look at you.
I'm look at that prick with his popped collar. He turns around, his eyes are at the top of his head. I'm
I was in an accident!
But yeah, pop collar is not a good look. I remember the cool kids.
The collar hides my back knee. It's endemic.
The cool kids in high school used to pop their collars, yeah. And it was the immediate sign of a fucking loser. Oh my god! I remember when I used to in high school. I used to button my the buttons on my polo shirt pretty much up all the way.
Yeah,
no, you always leave
until,
one undone.
Yeah, until year eight when a friend was "Hey, you can't don't fucking do that. You look like a nerd." Okay. Undo one of them, and I was
"Oh man!"
And he's "Undo two of them, fucking let it all hang out."
Undo the third, man.
Yeah, I think some days I used to have it half unbuttoned, so it was showing titties.
I would unbutton two, so it was a little tiny bit of chest, but not enough to be not enough for people to yank it down and look at my titties or something.
One time when I was in secondary school,
that never happened.
I had a really runny nose and I was just wiping it on my sleeve and I thought I was being really subtle about it until someone took me aside. I was like, "Hey man, you should probably go to the bathroom." Go to the bathroom. My face is covered in dried snot and my sleeves are almost full white with it. Wow. And I'm just like,
"You're green with it.
No one's going to notice." Someone's like, "Hey, maybe you should blow your nose or something." And I moved schools shortly after.
I used to get a weird thrill out of picking my nose in public and wiping it in public places. What the fuck? Yeah.
No, back of people's
just on
you, so you watch someone hey Ethan,
just on tramps.
Watch this kid.
The underside
this kid
of
goes to open
seats.
His pencil case and he's full of your boogers. Yeah.
No, just on the underside of tramps where you know that someone's going to put their hands on.
Oh my god!
I don't do it anymore.
That's where I go looking for chewing gum.
Put it in your mouth the rest of us.
There was a kid in high school who used to feel the underside of the feel gum on the underside of the table and just play with it. Yeah. Seem smiling to himself about it.
Yeah, because he feels like he's tip of a dick.
Oh my god. Speaking of the tip of dicks and tables and school.
You got an erection, you stood up and knocked the family dinner over.
I was sitting next to a friend in
they were carving the turkey as he stood
this
up.
This was in this was early in year seven.
Yeah.
But me and a friend were sat next to each other in science class. We were just talking shit. And you're a little kid, you talk about boners all the time.
Yeah.
What else?
No, I never once talked about my boners.
Really?
Well, that's because you didn't
I didn't really give a shit. I didn't care much for talking about boners at the time. Now
the only time
it.
Any of me or my friends talked about boners or anything like that was the kid was like, "Oh, watch porn once. I really, just to see what I didn't like it. And I was like, yeah, me too.
Fucking love porn. No, so this, this kid, didn't mind talking about boners, which, no, but we're in science class.
No, I'm pretty sure
he's he leans back. He's like, "Hey, dude, check it out. I got a boner." points down at his lap. And I'm like, "Oh, bullshit." And I'm like, I grab his cross.
Oh my god!
And I immediately recoiled in horror. We both were just like, "Ah!" He's like, "What'd you do?" And I'm like, "I didn't thought you were bullshitting."
Okay,
it was just because you have sometimes your jeans.
What was the possible outcome?
Like
either you look like you're going for dick, but you didn't get it, or you accidentally touched dick.
Yeah, I don't know why it was. That's, I don't know what the thought
that's the
was.
That's the automated response for anyone that has a tower is just to smash it.
Oh, I wish
did I
wish girls work that way.
Slapping motion.
Did I tell,
hey, check
and,
it
and
out.
He was like, ooh. He was like, we both just went and then there was a few seconds of just us with our hands on the desk, looking like we just hit hit someone with our car or something.
Yeah.
He's like, "What do we do? What do we do?"
We
and he's like,
"Act natural."
And he was like, What you doing, man? I'm just like, I don't know. I thought you were bullshitting.
You're as much to blame as I am.
And he's like, and then he ended up being like, oh, I didn't actually have a boner. It was, I had, you know, I told you about that keychain my nan has, and it's like a dick and it jumps around. I'm like, yeah. He's like, I put that in my pocket. Just, it was fun.
Yeah.
And that saved the, like, the heterosexual friend. That popped into my head the other day. It was like a repressed
memory. Yeah, when you were masturbating, you're like, oh, this feels like...
This feels like that kid's dick I touched. Oh. We were both kids, though. I should...
When you remember, the memory's all that much
He was in year seven and I was in his class.
You were also in year seven.
I don't know. I feel like all my friends were like super repressed about that kind of thing. Like if I went to a sleepover, we'd all just kind of get changed inside our sleeping bags and stuff. Heaven forbid someone saw us like in our underwear. Did I tell you one time I got stuck in my sleeping bag?
No.
I crawled like inside my sleeping bag.
And the foreskin got caught at the very bottom of the zip.
I tried to turn around like
a pug.
The sleeping bag, and halfway through I was like, oh no. I couldn't go forward and I couldn't go back.
That would terrify me.
Yeah, well, it terrified me. I was like, unzip it! Unzip it! I'm stuck! I thought I was gonna die.
I unzipped it and it's just full of piss and shit.
Billy Connolly has this amazing story about being high with this girl and they're fucking in a sleeping bag. And the girl was like, kind of like, I guess freaky would be the word. They were like fucking in a sleeping bag. She's like, you know, where Billy? I'll try this. And like zips up the sleeping bag all the way and like does the cord at the top. So they're just like getting all Dutch sweaty ovens. And fucking and stuff. And then she they were both like really drunk.
Yeah.
I think she might have been high.
Yeah.
She started vomiting and she was trying to like not to vomit on that. So she was vomiting at a tiny hole. God, couldn't get open, so it looked like this big caterpillar thing just like vomiting through his hole. And Billy's like screaming through the hole, just trying to vomit, going, help, help. And a roommate comes in and just sees this fucking thing.
That's amazing. Oh, shit. They're gonna say she zipped it up and fucking pissed and shit.
Oh, no.
When they unzipped me and just pissed and shit, everyone's like, I didn't know how long I'd be down there for. It felt like a lifetime.
I thought I'd save time.
Time.
There was no time.
Time moves differently.
There was no time to waste.
I'm not used to outside life. I want to go back to the sleeping bag. I don't know any different life now.
Yeah. You had to eat the piss and shit before it got cold to maintain sustenance.
20
oh, fuck. Seconds, Ethan.
Oh, man.
Oh, it didn't get cold.
So, Avengers 2
comes
out.
When was the last time you got trapped?
Let's talk about movies. Let's talk about movies and shit. Because there's a bunch of trailers and stuff that you're hyped for. Or one in particular.
One movie.
To rule them all.
Jurassic Park.
No, it's going to be the single greatest achievement, cinematic achievement.
Yeah.
Of all mankind.
Yeah.
Tusk.
Surpassing
Tusk.
Even Amazing Spider-Man 2. I am...
Speaking of course.
I'm all in for Star Wars 7.
Yep.
I've like...
What's it called?
Force Awakens.
Yeah.
I have gone just like... Everything I am depends on this movie.
Yeah, it's so weird because like...
That movie's going to break
first,
me
when the first teaser
out.
Came out, you're like, yeah, I'm excited, but you know, I'll keep it,
no.
You know, kind of lit no. on it. But now you're just like all in with the hype train like...
For this done. One.
I'm yeah, pretty much. I'm like
there is
I'm
not,
excited for it.
There is not a fiber of my being that is not
excited,
wholly devoted to Star Wars
wow.
7. Now,
are you watching,
like wholly
devoted
all the
that's
beings?
My,
wholly
that's
devoted
my second
to, like,
coming.
So, like, you're devoted to it. Like, you're saying, like, you're devoted to it. Like, in
like
sense,
the, okay, the rapture could happen, and I would only be mad because I wouldn't get to see Star Wars.
No,
7.
No, no. I mean, like,
complain ahead.
So you're like, you are convinced that this is going to be amazing.
Yes.
It's not just like you're devoted to hoping it's going to be amazing.
No,
you're
no,
convinced
no, no,
it will be.
No. I am.
That's cool.
I am all in. All
right. Yeah. No, I think it'll be really good too.
If it's average,
yeah.
I'm going to walk into traffic. I'm going
to
hold up a sign.
You said to me
my suicide note is just going to be like, blame JJ.
You said to me the other day that like no matter what happens, you're crying at the end of that film.
Yes.
Yep.
Either because it fulfilled every single wish I have.
Yep.
Or because it didn't fulfill a single one.
Everybody walks out of that movie happier, richer, and with a bigger dick.
Yes.
Even the girls, especially born. The girls. And I'll be there to grab all of them just to make sure.
Conversely, you'll be at the door Jurassic put World.
On... Jurassic World, I think, looks cool. I'm actually excited for that.
The dinosaurs look dodgy to me.
They look more CG than the original ones.
Are you watching?
How did you manage that?
Well, because the original ones were animatronics.
Yeah, like, weren't mostly, they like I actual think. Thing?
Yeah, yeah, it was.
But like the big T Rex.
I've forgotten the guy's name, but he.
Brad Bird.
Was it Brad Bird?
No.
Oh.
No.
The dude who made those dinosaurs worked Daffy on Dog. Like special effects for so many movies. Like he died in 2008, I think.
Oh shit!
Yeah, but him and his company worked on like fucking everything, like the Alien Queen, which and all the stuff he's worked on looks great today. Like the Alien Queen, the Predator.
It helps that a lot of the movies he worked thing, on the, were very the like in the thing. Dark well, no, that, movies.
That's the thing. If you do like animatronics or physical real life like media and it looks good, it's always going to look good.
It's kind of timeless.
You can't improve on like real life. The actual thing, looks good. Yeah.
Well, what I'm saying, like the thing, Alien, even Predator and Jurassic
Arnold
Park.
Schwarzenegger.
Yeah.
Most of the scenes with like the dinosaurs, the animatronic stuff, nighttime. Like most of that.
I mean, they'd find ways to shoot in a way that enhances the look of
them. You look at Jurassic World and it's like bright daytime shots, so the CG stands out more.
Yeah. I am still excited for it though. Like, I'm looking forward to watching it. Like, I think it'll either be dumb fun or so bad it's good.
I hope it's not that second one.
No, I'm not.
So bad it's good.
I'm not a dinosaur Nazi. I'm just a regular Nazi.
Yeah. What would the dinosaur Nazi be against dinosaurs?
Shut the front door, my good friend. No, are they doing
like
Jurassic
some sort
Park?
Of fun police for
Are they doing
dinosaurs?
Jurassic Park dinosaurs or are they doing ones with feathers and all this updated shit?
Jurassic Park dinosaurs.
Yeah. No, I was kidding. Like, I haven't seen anything. Have you guys watched like all the media that's out for it?
Yeah.
Why?
I watched because so far it's just been teasers.
Like why though? If you know you're gonna see it, why?
Well, now I know I'm gonna see it. Mm. I
Star Wars. I can't help myself.
Okay. So Connor, are you gonna cease watching anything else Jurassic Park related?
It comes out like next week, doesn't
it? Yeah. Really? No, next week. Okay. I don't think so. I think it comes out June.
Oh, right. I don't know. I don't care.
I'm excited for it. Like I might avoid it. Like it's the thing is. I don't think it's going to be amazing. I think it's going to be a bit of dumb fun or so bad it's good. Okay. So I'm kind of, I don't mind watching trailers and spoiling it for myself because I'm not that, devoted.
I'd rather
to
want
to
watch as much new footage of anything.
Yeah, I guess I totally see where
I
you're
enjoy
coming from.
Most movies,
but I don't really give a shit.
Yeah, fair enough. I think that's why I enjoy most movies because I have no fucking idea what's about to happen.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
Everything's new to take in. Yeah. I don't have time to sit down and be like, I've seen this. What's weird about this?
A movie that we'll be seeing later this week and doing a spoiler cast, hopefully, is Avengers 2, Age of Ultron, which I watched the first trailer that came out, like the teaser with Ultron in it and stuff, and I haven't watched anything since, and I'm really excited for that movie. I'm really glad that I haven't watched any of the promotional shit for that.
Yeah,
all I know is that Hulk fights...
Iron Man,
because that was all over Facebook at some point.
I want to see that Hulkbuster armor. Yeah. We saw the Hulkbuster armor
at Supernova. It's huge.
I don't know what that is.
Hulkbuster is Iron Man.
I don't want to watch it.
All right. You don't want to know?
No, I just know. I know they fight each other. That's
okay,
it,
all right. We'll not tell you how. But it looks really cool. Looks really fun, and I'm excited for that. There's another trailer
Wait,
came out recently.
Is Avengers 2 after Iron Man 3?
Yes.
Yes.
How does Iron Man do kicks and shit now? Because, like, didn't he get his core or whatever the fuck removed?
The core was like a thing that he built. So he could just build another one outside of the suit.
Yeah. Why do you have that?
Because
it was stopping a piece of shrapnel.
There was shrapnel in his chest.
Was this in Iron Man 1?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was attached to like an electromagnet to keep the shrapnel out of his heart.
Huh.
Yeah. It's a bit silly, but
okay. So he's the same person he was without that.
Yeah, yes. He can still
it didn't
be
give
Iron
him
Man.
Any kind of like
he just doesn't glow.
I think
support.
It was just like a. I think it was there.
Well,
it was to keep.
But then
he
had that big surgery.
No. Yeah. I mean like supplementary. Like,
I didn't give him anything extra. I think he kept it. He kept it as just like a reminder kind of thing or something.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
And that was the whole big deal.
And he got rid of like all his suits and shit.
Yeah, yeah, he did. But obviously he's going to start again.
I don't know. They'll probably visit that in
Well, the suits, he made all those suits as part of like a PTSD thing because he felt powerless when he was falling from the sky and stuff. So like
he
never wanted to be in that situation again. So he just kept building all these suits.
I thought he had them from
the other thing.
Oh, okay.
No. I mean, he had a few suits.
Yeah.
Okay.
But mate, basically, they wanted to sell a bunch of action figures.
No, for the end of Iron Man 3, like
I
thought he was getting rid of it. It made it look like he was just a regular guy. I think he was just
starting from the base.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, I thought
started from the bottom. Now
I thought it was implied he was hanging up his boots.
Nah,
Well, I'm sure they'll address it in Iron Man 3.
Yeah, yeah.
In Avengers.
Avengers 2.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Like, I don't. You say like they did that to sell toys, which is probably like
absolutely. True.
Yeah, no, no, no. Oh, but definitely. Like, I
every single one of those suits has an individual suit.
Yeah, 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 yeah. But like the Batman Forever and Batman and Robin movies were made pretty much just to sell toys.
Yeah,
and I mean, I think from Batman Returns onwards was made to sell toys because like Batman Returns had a Happy Meal attached to it.
Hmm.
Like, what? They had a Happy Meal that had like Batman Returns.
Oh, I think that the movie came with a Happy Meal. Well,
no, 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 fuck. No, no, no. Like, no, I mean, no.
You can still buy
every
DVDs.
Movie had a Happy Meal
instead of it. You'd
to
say,
it.
"Can I get a ticket for this?" And they just get handed.
They got a burger
meal.
Stapled to the movie package.
But like those movies,
you gotta
were,
take the pickles off it to see what seat you're in.
Those movies are like terrible. Like they're
terrible. They're,
they're shit.
They got their place.
No, they're schlocky like and Batman. Shit.
The one with
if you like schlocky shit, then yeah, they're
Jack Nicholson Joker is quite good.
No, no, Jack Nicholson Joker. That's good. But I'm talking like the last two, the Joel Schumacher ones.
George Clooney ones?
Yeah, yeah, with the nipples on the suit. Yeah, and those like really weird campy ones.
Is that the gray and blue?
No, gray and blue is Adam West and stuff
Adam
like really
Reed.
Old.
Oh, no, I don't know how far they continued. Because when I was a kid, no. I had a Batman toy and it was gray and blue suit and then Batman was all in black and I was like, wait, what the fuck? Like,
yeah.
I didn't really follow anything superhero.
Oh, there was like a big change once. Like,
yeah. I think
I want to say Frank Miller, but I don't think that's true.
It was weird because the only Batman
they changed the tone of Batman from being like goofy, kind of like circus tricks and
like anti-hero
pun based villains to like anti-hero.
Yeah, but like you know, along
like way darker.
Yeah, yeah, like fucking deep shit.
But yeah, like Iron Man. Sorry, with the, just let me finish this thought real quick. Yeah, Iron Man 3 being like made to sell toys partially. I don't mind because at least the movie was cool.
Yeah,
yeah. Well, I think there's like a point where like. Maybe the directors are just like, okay, so he's made 5 suits at this point. Then Disney kind of swooped and be like, hey, you can make it 30 suits. And they're like, well, this doesn't really have an impact on the story.
Yeah, exactly.
And there's that cool scene where all the suits come at the
and
end.
And the suits were, yeah, the suits were really cool so far.
There wasn't a Hulkbuster armor in that. It was like a construction armor, apparently. Because it was like a big, bulky armor.
That seems with pretty much every sci-fi thing, what? Any kind of like tanky looking mech suit that's just like a fat dude, essentially, is always like, this was a loader repurposed for combat.
Yeah, in Alien,
that's like
everything. The loader that she rides at the end.
Yeah.
It wasn't like a combat thing. It was just for moving crates, wasn't it?
It was, I think, like around about when Avatar
came out.
Designed
to fight aliens.
Yeah. When Avatar around about came out, Halo Wars and Gears of War 3 were like ish. They had Avatar, I know that was like, I don't know if it was a combat loader. I didn't
know. No, that was a full military thing.
Yeah, but like. I'm guessing it was probably combat, like, you know, some kind of loader or something.
But it had like guns, generally.
Yeah.
It had hands, I think, that pull triggers on giant guns.
Yeah, the Cyclopses in Halo Wars, like, they look the exact same, and it's like, oh, this is a loader, but people have, you know, a little bit of more armor. And then in Gears, they had the exact same thing. I can't remember what it was called. And then it's like, oh, it was a loader, but now it has guns.
Were the
and
ones
then, like,
in Halo 4,
had,
like, derivative of the ones in Halo 3? Because those were just full, like,
no, that was
mechs.
Not in Halo 3. I think they were
The ones in Halo 4, were they derivative of the ones in Halo Wars?
No, I don't think there was any link. Halo Wars had a lot of unique shit. I think that was just straight up. But by that point, everything had fucking loaders that were then combat, like, mech suits.
Yeah, that's cool.
I feel like that was a bit earlier than Avatar.
What? Halo Wars?
The whole mech thing.
I feel it started around, like, they all kind of started around that same-ish point.
Yeah.
But Avatar would have been in development a long time before.
Mm. Avatar was in development.
But, I mean, those
years,
games, like Halo and
years.
Gears of War and stuff, they're Space Marine games, and, like, Aliens kind of, like, they started the whole Space Marines kind of shtick, didn't they?
Wait, what?
Aliens.
The alien movie Aliens, like, because that had
Marines.
A mech thing. Yeah, totally
mech
Space
thing,
Marines.
But like,
oh, maybe Halo. Gears is just set on, like, another world, like, another Earth, essentially, and it's
yeah.
the people bothered.
I feel like StarCraft, the game, came up before Aliens did. Or maybe it didn't, but, like...
Really?
I feel like video games had, like, mechs and Space Marines before Alien did. Warhammer, like, they've always had, like, Space Marines.
Yeah. How old is Warhammer?
Man, I don't know. Emma would be able to tell us.
Yeah. Real quick, the dude who did the effects on Jurassic Park was called Stan Winston, and his company did... So they did the dinosaurs in Jurassic Park 1, 2, and 3. They did the thing in... They did the dog thing from the thing. They did the Terminator makeup and, stuff.
Yeah.
Queen Alien, a bunch of monsters, Wolfman, Predator, Pumpkinhead, Edward Scissorhands.
The Queen Alien wasn't done by the... Dutch guy?
Scissorhands, really?
He might have been designed, but the thing was built by this guy's company.
Okay.
Penguin in Batman Returns.
Oh, the makeup.
Yeah,
wasn't he a normal guy?
No, he had like conjoined fingers to make him have fins.
Yeah, and he was fat. He had like a fat suit and stuff.
Oh, okay. No, I didn't realize. I thought he only did like horror makeup, not like general SFX as well.
He actually did some his company at least did some of the effects in Avatar, like creature design and stuff, and Iron Man.
Concept design. They probably would have done. Thing. Yeah.
And
Alien came out in 1987. Alien came out in 1979.
Yeah.
And Warhammer came out in 1987.
Oh, okay.
Fuck, Warhammer's old. I didn't realize.
Alien's 10 years older. But,
I never thought about how old Warhammer was. I just know it's a thing.
Yeah.
But this Stan Winston guy also did the creature designs.
Oh, D&D would have come out in, like, I think, like, the 60s. D&D's
really? Fuck me. I just know it exists.
Yeah. It's still just, like, book-based, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought the video game
I went with Caitlin, like, a few years ago. She bought, like, one of the, like, the Dungeon Master booklets. Uh-huh. And, they've just got editions they re-release every
year. We used to have the Dungeon, like, the rule book and, like, the Monster book.
Yeah.
Like, first editions.
That's cool.
Why don't we do that? We're fucking retarded.
Yeah,
because you're awful to play games with.
Yeah.
This Stan Winston dude also did the little monster, the little characters in Small Soldiers, and that
Small
movie
Soldiers.
Is fucking awesome.
Shit.
Didn't realize until I was watching it that that's directed by Joe Dante, the guy who did Gremlins 1 and 2, and like Gremlins scared the shit out of me as a kid.
I can see
that. And Small Soldiers scared the shit out of me as a kid. So Joe Dante is good at scaring me.
Was Hulk Hogan in Small Soldiers?
No, wait, no, it wasn't.
Really?
Hulk Hogan is in Gremlins 2, and it's amazing.
In the middle of Gremlins 2, the film just cuts out.
This completely, like, fourth wall breaking moment. Yeah. It's amazing.
So the film just, like, cuts out, and it shows the projection booth for the, ostensibly, the cinema that you're watching it in. It's just full of gremlins messing with the film.
Yeah.
And of all people, Hulk Hogan stands up. He's like,
the usher
comes and finds Hulk Hogan. He's like, hey, Hulk, we've got some gremlins. Could you deal with them?
And he's like, what? Gremlins?
He's like, get out of there or I'll bring Hulkamania.
What the fuck? You know Mikey is still saying Hulkamania shit.
And then he like turns to the camera. He's like, enjoy the movie, folks, and winks or something like
what
that. It's ridiculous.
That's fantastic.
It's amazing.
I guess at the time it would have been jarring, but that makes that movie like that timeless to me.
I think I've said this on the podcast
that
before.
That was the final destination of the hype train.
I've said this before on the podcast, like when I watched Gremlins 2 like recently, I brought it up. But I think Gremlins 2 is like better than Gremlins 1. Like it's funny. it's funnier. Like Gremlins 1 has that,
I can't remember
has that
much
kind
of either,
like, oh, it's really charming, like old and like it still holds up and stuff. But Gremlins 2 is funnier. So Small Soldiers, Joe Dante is really good at like taking like little like
we should
starts
play some
off
of
with
small
like
soldiers
one or two
on
like
video
yeah
stream.
Totally
they have games?
Starts with like one or two little monster things and by the end of the movie it's like hundreds of them and they're fucking shit up and it's always like he's really good at taking like mundane kind of suburban settings and injecting them with just fucking craziness
and now he's
and
doing
insanity.
Episodes of Hawaii Five-0.
Oh, Joe. The man's got to eat.
Yeah, I don't think he wants to be doing that. I imagine he wants to be doing Gremlins 3.
But,
I did some Masters of Horror.
Yeah, dude, Small Soldiers is fucking awesome.
Did you watch it again after we talked about it at Supernova?
I think I'd watched it just before we talked about it at Supernova. I watched it like somewhat recently. Because Caitlin hadn't seen it. I was like, this shit's legit. And it's really good. It's legit.
Did you ask if you could bring me?
I haven't seen it.
No, I didn't.
Oh, fucker.
She looked at me. She's like, "If you invite Guy,
if you invite
I'm dumping
Guy,
him.
Right? So what about me?
What about
said about
me?
You as well? She said, don't do it.
Right, great. Right.
Don't do
no,
it.
No, Caitlin cast. Great. We're calling this one.
So with Avengers 2 coming up,
Avengers.
I watched. I've been watching some more Marvel movies because I hadn't for the first.
I've seen all of them.
First phase
all of them in cinemas.
For the first phase of Marvel, cinematic universe thing. I only saw the first Iron Man, and then
I
went straight
really
in.
As into comics as you are now. Then
no, I wasn't. But then this time I managed to see pretty much all of them except Captain America, and then I watched Captain America:
oh, I haven't
The Winter
seen
Soldier
that,
the other day.
Yeah.
It was really cool.
Wait, is that the second or the first?
That's
one?
The second one.
Fuck me, there's two of them.
Winter Soldier is the second one, yeah.
Sorry, just I'll point this out here. If you're interested in Small Soldiers, just as a point of reference, there is a dedicated Small Soldiers wiki that you can check.
Oh, excellent.
So I'm glad
that
exists.
Look up the Gorgonites and that.
Yeah, Small Soldiers wiki, which is, of all the things that needed to be catalogued, I'd say Small Soldiers is the most important.
Yeah.
Well, yeah,
it's number two after Sonic.
You can pick anything. and there'll be a wiki for it.
Like I love that.
Ethan Miles.
Ethan Miles wiki. Let's go.
As you're while you're searching
no,
that
wiki.
Yeah, wiki, Captain wiki, America 2 was really cool. The fight scenes were really sick. And like
I can just make one now.
Do it.
Sorry, go.
I was thinking because I started watching Daredevil as well recently. And does that take place in the like within that universe? Because they keep referencing like something happening in New York.
Daredevil is in the Marvel Cinematic Universe.
The show is.
Yeah,
that's really cool.
I think that's my favorite thing set in that universe.
Well, yeah, I didn't know that going in. So when they're talking about,
rebuilding New York. Yeah,
the sky opened up and shit happened. Like I was like, oh shit, they're talking about Avengers.
It's set against the backdrop of that, and there's all this like corruption in the rebuilding effort.
That's cool. I've only started watching that, and I'm gonna keep doing that. It's good stuff.
I would hate to live in them because it seems like every fucking town gets destroyed on like a bi-weekly basis.
Well, every like major American city does.
Yeah, I'm like fuck, rebuilding.
It's that thing where that. Like,
but the problem is, if like
every disaster movie is set in like New York or whatever,
but you wanna, like,
Australia
live,
is fine.
You want to live like in one of those like little out. There's like little suburban towns,
but that's where all the horror movies take place.
No, but those are the ones that just get like flat out destroyed.
Yeah,
like New York gets beat up and stuff, but New York never gets like nuked. Anything.
You don't want to live in like just a like one thing on an island, though.
Yeah,
that's when occasionally it just comically gets crushed by something.
Yeah, you want to like find the perfect middle ground.
Yeah,
maybe like one of
just,
the smallest.
Just kind of
maybe just on the edge, like, just on the edge of major cities.
Yeah, move to Detroit,
yeah, suburbia
or something, and then smash Detroit up and it'll look better.
Yeah, no, dear God, no.
Move to Traralgon.
No, you want to fucking live in Nidri.
Oh,
when the world starts down, you want to go to Nidri.
Do you know
what
would be,
shit.
Do you know what would be amazing?
What?
If, like, I don't
if
know.
Traralgon was destroyed in real life? Yeah.
No, I don't know the plot of Avengers 2, but I'm saying, like, they do, like, an alien invasion thing.
God.
And they do that thing where they show, like, different cities around the world, like the Big Ben getting knocked over by aliens. And then I cut to Traralgon.
The Traralgon town well being slightly nudged.
It's just like an alien doing a shit in the Traralgon town well. The mayor being like,
the mayor, no, because then the mayor would fight the aliens.
That's my shooting hole.
another Marvel movie I watched recently.
He has like the mayor of Traralgon has like superpowers. He's just got like a super abusive authority thing he can do. I'll redirect funds to pay for my golden toilet seat.
Well, his duster deflects lasers.
Yeah, true.
Another speaking of dusters, another Marvel movie I watched recently that has no ties to the Marvel Cinematic Universe as it is now. The Punisher 2004 movie with Tom Jane and what's his face, John Travolta.
Really?
Yeah.
Tom Jane did a Punisher short that was actually really good.
I didn't. Apparently that was good. It was like for Comic Con, I think. Yeah. There's a second movie called Punisher Warzone, which I don't know if it's any better.
Punisher 2.
But like
Punisher.
It was so weird to watch. It doesn't feel like, because like
kept rewarding everyone.
The Marvel movies, the Marvel movies now like have a kind of feel to them. Like you kind
yeah
of know
yeah
you're
it's
watching
the same
a Marvel
like
movie.
If you watch Blade, it's just what the fuck is
going
on?
Like, this is a comic book movie, Jesus. But you watch it and it feels more like you're watching like an old school like 80s action movie, like but not one of the good ones, one of the kind of straight to VHS ones,
like anything with Steven Seagal in.
Yeah, or Seagal. What's his fucking name, which funnily enough the original Punisher movie had Dolph Lundgren in it, so it feels still like one of those movies that's kind of a bit shit and you know, kind of weird. And the Punisher is like, he doesn't really punish anybody until the end. It's a 2.5 hour. It's a 2 hour movie. It's like 2 hours and 4 minutes. And for the first 90 minutes, he doesn't really punish anyone. He just kind of goes around like fucking with John Travolta, who's like the main bad guy. He's more or less the angsty prankster. Like he's just kind of like looking sad, and he keeps pulling these funny little pranks to make John Travolta think that his wife is fucking his like his best friend, his right hand man or whatever. And John Travolta's character is the most gullible fucking idiot on the planet. It's amazing. So you've got the angsty prankster versus the most gullible man alive. Okay. Like
it sounds like a straight to VHS. Like,
no, it sounds like the plot of an Archie comic.
Yeah, it's fucking ridiculous. No,
speaking of which, Punisher did a crossover with Archie once.
Really?
Yeah.
You punish them?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Thinking Home Alone. That's it.
Yeah. He it was pretty much Home Alone with guns.
Home Alone had guns.
He what's he do? He keeps like moving his wife's car to like different locations while she's not driving it, and like getting it back in time.
No, what she is driving.
And then she
looks at the
he finds out that
mile
the
meter, and she's like, I don't remember driving those extra 10 kilometers on Asia.
And like blackmailing the best friend who's gay, but like
John Travolta. I thought you meant there was a character called John Travolta.
For some reason, like this,
blackmailing
the yeah. John Travolta's best friend, his right hand man, like his you know his hitman friend, is gay. But John Travolta doesn't know, and the guy doesn't want anybody knowing. And so Punisher finds out about this and makes it look like the best friend and the wife are fucking by like just doing like weird little shit that doesn't, it isn't really indicative of anything.
Yeah, but.
And then he like goes to, he takes like an earring that that John Travolta bought for his wife, takes like one of them and puts it in the middle of the best friend's bed, like just on the dude's bed.
Yeah, like, so, as like if John, you're gonna find
yeah,
it.
Well, John Travolta walks in, finds this one earring in the middle of the bed, and is like, "Motherfucker!" And just like just sees that and just goes with it. And he's like, "They're fucking. I'm gonna put a stop to that."
What's the other? What's his right hand man's name?
The sack, Jack. Quentin.
Quentin. So like he takes like he takes. Who the fuck's the bad guy? I've lost so much interest in this.
What's John
Travolta. He takes John Travolta's wife's like shits and rubs them on whoever the fuck the right hand man's dick. So when he's sucking him off, he's like, "This tastes like my wife. You've been fucking my wife."
It feels like the Punisher could have literally just like rang up John Travolta and be like, "Hey, dude, Quentin wrote Gullible on your ceiling."
Yeah.
And John would be like, "Motherfucker."
He orders.
I'm not even going to look up. Yeah. I'm going to storm to his house right now.
He orders and, 50 pizzas. He sends them to him, and all the pizza topping arranged says, "I'm fucking your wife." Heart, Quentin.
Hey, is your fridge Quentin. Running? Yeah.
Quentin's fucking your wife.
He ends up stabbing Quentin to death. And he ends up like stabbing him to death. I can't remember what he says, but it's just like a really bad line. Stabs him to
it's
death.
It's just
and
then, being revoked.
Then his wife
pulls out his heart.
Let's call her Cheryl. Sure. He finds Cheryl and he's like, "I know about you and Quentin." And the wife like knew that Quentin was gay. Like they were friends and stuff. They were close, but not fucking close. And he's like, she's like, "What are you talking about?" And he's like, "Oh no, you're fucking Quentin." And she's like, She goes, "How?" I think his name was Howard. He's like, "Howard, Quentin's gay." And he's like, "Don't you try to fucking, don't lie to me," and like hits her.
Quentin's gay.
And that made me laugh so hard because he's just like, why is that like, why is that so inconceivable?
Reaction?
Like, yeah. And like, why wouldn't you be like, he, like, and it made me laugh too when like he's beating Quentin up saying like, "I know you're fucking my wife." Quentin could literally just be like, "Nah, dude, I'm gay."
Yeah.
And Howard'd be like, "Oh, fuck off. Really? That's good for you, man. You out yet?
Really?
Let's have a cup of tea."
But do you think that would happen?
Because, like, there's no indication.
Gay.
There's no indication that John Travolta's character is homophobic.
Yeah.
So it looks like he could have easily just been like, "Dude, no, I'm not fucking your wife. I'm gay."
Do you think John Travolta would play a character that wasn't homophobic?
You think John Travolta was a homophobe?
I think a man as closeted as he is wouldn't want to be seen on screen accepting gay people.
You think he's, like, that closeted?
I do.
I don't know enough about John Travolta.
He's not homophobic in the thing.
Anyway, like, the character just wasn't homophobic, so I just thought that was funny as fuck. Yeah. And then his wife, he like, you know, slaps her and around and shit, and he like he's in the limo. He gets in the limo with her, and she's like, you know, sitting there. She's like, "Please, can we just talk about this, honey?" And he's like, "No." And then they get out of the limo on a bridge. And she's like, "Please, honey, this doesn't make sense." And he grabs her and kisses her. He's like, "I know." And then picks her up and throws her off a bridge. And she like, and you're like, "Holy shit!" And then it cuts to her down, and she's landed on her face, like on the train tracks, and is completely fine. She kind of lifts herself up, and a train hits her.
Oh my god!
And she's like, "Ah!" And like,
"What? Wait, the train is gay."
Yeah. It was just so fucking goofy.
What the fuck?
Oh my god. And like,
yeah, the Punisher is punishing,
and then the
you
Punisher finally like comes
movie.
In, and it reminded me a lot of this Arnold Schwarzenegger movie called Raw Deal, which like a lot of kind of nothing happens for the first, you know, 70 minutes, and then the last 20 he goes in and like storms the bad guy's thing and gets his revenge.
Storms
and it's pretty
into
much
room.
Storms into his
slams
room.
The door.
Yeah,
"I'm not coming out.
I'm going to rearrange your things.
I'm watching Netflix. Fuck off." Shark boy and lava girl.
3D.
He ends up like, so Punisher ends up punishing all these dudes, killing them and stuff, and he ends up like getting John Travolta, and John Travolta goes out like a fucking punk. Like, he ends up getting John Travolta, shooting John Travolta once, and you think there's gonna be like a really like cool standoff thing, but he pulls out his gun, shoots him. He's on the ground. He like grabs him, ties him to his car, and like puts an explosive on the back of the car, and then puts the car into drive,
yeah,
and somehow like has it going forward. Even it's not on a slope, he just puts it into drive, and like it's going forward into the parking lot of this dude's like building where all these gangsters are.
Church.
And then Punisher's like walking off and like detonates the thing. And instead of just detonating the one car like that he's tied to, it blows up all the cars around him
as well.
But they're all blowing up at a distance that it's not hurting John Travolta. He's maybe getting a bit hot, but he's just like being dragged along slowly at maybe like 5 miles an hour behind this car going, and he's kind of, and it's John Travolta where he's kind of chubby.
Yeah,
so it's this
chubby
John Travolta being like, and then the car, like, it's weird. The car that he explodes, the boot of the limo that he explodes, but the cable that he's tied John Travolta to is too long, so it doesn't really even hit him, but like then it cuts back and he's suddenly on fire.
Yeah.
So it's like a really weird kind of just annoyingly unsatisfying death scene. But then like you're wondering why he's blown up all these cars, and that shows like an aerial shot, and the pattern that he's like exploded the cars in makes
a big swastika.
Yeah. No, a big Punisher skull, and you're just like, that's kind of fun.
It's a big like penis.
Oh, and this dude gets taught, this dude, like one of his neighbors in this like rundown place.
I like the Punisher outfit, like the costume for Punisher.
It's cool.
Like I just wear the t-shirt.
Yeah, the t-shirt and the big, you know, duster. But the bit, there's a bit where this dude in the building that he like makes friends with, like a fat Italian guy, some crim kind of young dude with like piercings, and some chick who wants to bone him, and he doesn't bone the chick, and she's real sad about that.
The fat Italian guy.
The fat Italian guy is like
demands
just kind
of
there
off
to
the
be
chick.
Your armpits taste
the
like
fat
spaghetti.
Dude, the fat dude is literally at one point making spaghetti and eating pizza.
Oh my god.
And
and
he is singing that. He's either singing that or some other Italian like thing, like anyway. I think he's singing that. And so the fat Italian guy and the dude with the
catchphrase is "Oh garlic"
get like interrogated by these guys who come looking for Punisher, and the dude with the piercings like won't talk, so they like rip all his piercings out one by one, and it's like really sad and really painful. And then Punisher like gets out, and instead of being like, "Man, thanks for that," like, "Oh shit," he's like, "Why'd you do that? I brought you nothing but trouble." And the guy's like, and the dude's on the chair, and he's looking like fucking miserable. He's like, "Oh, cause your family and stuff." And Punisher like kind of walks over to him, just kind of like looks at him, puts his hand on his shoulder, and then says to someone else, like, "Take him to a hospital." And I was sitting there and I was watching, and I was just like, give him a hug.
Say thank you.
Say thank you and give him a fucking hug. This macho bullshit has to stop. Give him a fucking hug. Look at him. He looks like shit.
I'd hug you, but I don't want John Travolta to think I'm gay.
But yeah, it was just like really silly. Very silly movie.
I tell you, I watched Saving Mr. Banks.
You told me. Yeah, what'd you think?
Really, really nice movie.
Yeah, really sweet.
But I feel like one of those movies comes out every year.
A really like a movie that's just designed to be really sweet.
Yeah, no, a sequel to Saving Mr. Banks.
Saving Private Ryan.
Saving Ryan's private.
We saved Private Ryan.
Now we gotta save.
We gotta go
Disney.
Back for Mr. Banks.
Did you say we gotta save Walt Disney?
It's about Walt Disney.
Yeah.
But
it's
really,
like,
it's about Mary Poppins.
Yeah, it's a sweet movie.
Tom Hanks is good in that.
Ah, oh, really good.
Is there a movie that Tom Hanks isn't good in? We watch Tom Hanks. You're like,
so. I haven't watched that much Tom Hanks movies.
If Tom Hanks ran a hot dog stand, it'd be Tom Frank.
Supernova. We haven't
a proper count.
We haven't talked about. We went to Supernova the other day, the other week. It was cool. You know what?
It wasn't. A waste.
It was the same as it has been every year. Sorry, which has been nice. But they bumped the price up to $40.
Yeah. What was
and
it?
And it was not worth $40. Pardon?
What was it?
The experience?
No, what was Supernova? The old price?
Oh, the old price. When we first went, it was just under $30. It was like $28 for the day, which you could justify like to walk around, because you're basically paying to go in and spend more money.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't spend a dollar, and I got a free Evangelion poster, and I saw Simon Pegg and Nick Frost.
For the first year, yeah, that was a great
amazing year.
And then the years since then, I've like spent $40 to basically go in and look at other stuff that is either too expensive or to buy some like local prints and stuff, which is fun, but for $40, really not worth it.
Well, last year I saw I think it was 2 years ago, they did the Game of Thrones panel, which was really cool.
Yeah.
I guess made it worth it.
I think this is the first year that we've gone and there's not been any panel or
worth seeing
that we want to see.
There was a Power Rangers panel. Really? Yeah. Who gives a shit?
Yeah.
The fuck?
Why? There was a Mad Max coming out as well, I think, we missed.
Just like, fuck it, let's get
no, the Green. Oh, I think the Green Ranger was just doing a tour.
Mm.
There were tons of Power Rangers there.
Heaps of cosplayers, as usual.
The cosplays are always
I love
really
the cosplayers.
Cool.
I love, like...
what are you
going
to cosplay as?
Seeing the... we'll get on to that in a minute. Seeing the, like, really good cosplayers and really bad cosplayers and seeing, like, the local comics and local prints and local artists and stuff is my favorite part of Comic-Con and Supernova.
And seeing all the Bazinga shirts.
Ethan kept count.
No.
I counted every single Bazinga t-shirt.
I saw the status.
Yeah, and I added it. Like, I had my notes open on my phone, like, Bazinga count. And I was doing, like, oh, that's up. I was stuck on 9 for, like, honestly, an hour.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then we saw the best Bazinga shirt.
I can't remember. We were just at a stall for something. I kind of just starts, like, slapping me on the shoulder. Yeah, dude, points this out at this dude. And I'm like, oh, I thought he was pointing out a dude in a Bazinga t-shirt to me. I look over. It's just a dude in, like, a Tron t-shirt. I'm like, oh, whatever. And then I take a closer look. It's Sheldon. From Big Bang Theory as the guy from Tron, and in the same like Tron font it says Bazinga,
and we're just like,
that's number 10.
It was a very good moment
because it was like 10 asterisks one was not true.
No dude, that one was
that was
I count that one as like 5.
Yeah, that's the Bazinga, that's like, that's your golden Bazinga.
What the fuck?
You know when you do like, when you have like collectibles in video games, you'll have like...
Yeah, the gold one is
yeah, exactly.
3 or 5 points.
I don't know if we've ever talked to, like, because the first podcast we did, we talked about Comic-Con. I don't know if we talked about this on that podcast, but if not, we're fucking revisiting it. Speaking of cosplayers, would you guys ever cosplay as anything? And if you were to cosplay, what would you cosplay as?
Well, I have.
If you could cosplay as anything.
I have. It's Team Rocket twice.
Yeah, you have too. Well, that's a costume party though. If you went all out and there was like a costume that you'd really want to do, what would you want to do?
That's pretty much it.
Yeah,
I'd do an ODST. Simple
costumes. Yeah, there were some ODSTs there and a couple of Spartans.
ODSTs.
Both.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were cool.
Yeah,
I would never cosplay. There's nothing I like enough to dress up as.
That's fair enough.
I used to go on.
And there's nothing I like that looks enough like me to cosplay.
Yeah, I think like I might be cosplaying for Comic-Con this year with Kaylin, either as because like up until recently, or not so recently now, I had hair and there wasn't really much I could think of that I wanted to cosplay as. That I kind of looked like as well. So, but now, like, that I've shaved my head and I'm bald, there's like, it opens up a world of bald characters that I can cosplay as. Think Costanza, absolutely.
Krillin, yes.
No, me and Caitlin, I'm thinking of going as either Spider Jerusalem from Transmetropolitan.
Nah.
Or the Frenchie, the Frenchman from The Boys. And in either case, Caitlin would either be, I forgot her name.
Caitlin Tolsma.
The not Shannon.
Shrek.
The other girl from Transmet.
The one with the rich dad.
Yeah.
Sharon.
Claire.
Yeah.
It's not Claire.
Yolandi.
Yeah, I feel like it starts with Y as well for some reason.
Yelena. I think it's Yelena.
Yeah, Yelena.
She'd be going as Yelena, or if I went as Frenchie, she'd be going as the female from The Boys.
Cool.
Yeah.
I kind of want
to
learn.
But I'm not sure. Like, the Frenchman, I'd have to get, like, a duster coat and Doc Martens and, like, goggles, and that's, like, expensive.
Yeah, but then you get to own a duster.
That's the thing. I want a duster so bad.
Space cowboy.
If I can find one, I'll go as him. Otherwise.
Thing is, like, you don't want to do is what I see, like, some friends of mine that are, like, doing conventions in India and stuff, like, kids I went to high school, not friends.
Yeah.
Going to cons in, like, costume shop outfits.
Oh no.
So those really goofy looking like Captain America ones with like the padded muscle things. It's like you're in a room surrounded by people in costume that have spent like most of their life building a costume.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's a slap in the face to them be like, yeah, we're both in costume, eh?
Yeah.
How much did yours cost? Did you have to put a deposit down?
Yeah.
Well, I had to put a deposit down. It's like,
I reckon, yeah, I'll either one of those two, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I think I'm too self-conscious at this point to do Spider Jerusalem, because like Spider Jerusalem basically just wears like black like slacks and a suit jacket with like no shirt underneath, and I could like button it up so it'd just be my chest showing, sort of, not my titties, but like still, even then,
just staple it. Preacher. So it doesn't open up.
Hey,
I'll be Preacher.
Yeah,
you be Cassidy.
Yeah,
no, wait, you be girl.
I'll be Tulip.
Yeah, Tulip.
Yeah,
Caitlin can be Cassidy.
Yeah,
some great Irish accent probably.
Guy can be the Saint Killers.
I don't know what that is.
Saint Killers is like this character from Preacher that's essentially just Clint Eastwood, and he walks around with like a six a revolver
with infinite bullets that can fuck up tanks.
Yeah, essentially they melted the down. Was it the Grim Reaper's? It wasn't the Grim Reaper's scythe, was it? It was.
Oh, I can't remember.
He
killed Satan with it.
It was like the Angel of Death's sword, and they just melted down into a gun.
So yeah, cosplays. I might do that. I'd like to cosplay at least once in my life.
I'd like because
I see some costumes. Fuck I'm like, you. These are really cool, and I'd like to be part of this crowd.
Sure.
Some of them. That dude who stopped and talked to us in the supermarket, like, seemed like he might have Asperger's or some shit.
That's true.
Some guy was, like, in his big... we might have mentioned this last week.
I didn't think we did.
Some guy was in this trolley. Like, we went to Coles to get, like, food and stuff. Yep. And this guy dressed in, like, a full, like, cardboard cutout space... With a corset as well.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Two corsets, apparently. A cardboard cutout, like, space marine with a trolley in front of him with his, like, massive cardboard gun just in front of it, like... Like your costume?
Yeah.
Oh my.
No. He was like, we were like, oh, cool costume, dude. And he was like, yes, thank you. And like, pretty much went on a spiel. Like, he wow. quite clearly like was like, yeah. I'm a fucking space marine today. And like, good on him, but like, a bit cringy when it's made of cardboard.
And then that happened to me when like,
but I shouldn't be like that.
Friends, like, it was like friends of friends that like stopped and talked to us. And yeah. I recognized the costume.
Yeah.
And then they went on about the show it was from for like 10 minutes. Yeah. Like, I did not remember any of this. Yeah. Walk around, no.
I'm going to dye my dick blue and go naked.
And go Sonic. Dr. Manhattan. No?
Okay. Go Sonic. Dr. Manhattan on a fucking, like,
Dr. Sonic.
Crack binge.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd like to learn. I've seen it a few times. People go as real life. I've forgotten what it's called.
Memes. Oh, shit. Psychic Pebbles. Zach from Sleeper Cabin.
Yeah.
You know, this is really cool. I think it'll interest you. Posted a picture of the guy from
He reposted.
He retweeted a picture that someone had taken of this guy selling like meme masks at Supernova, Melbourne.
Yeah. And we'd saw him and gone, fuck that guy.
So we was like going through Psychic Pub. I was like, holy shit, that's our town. I was there that day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just neat.
Oh, shit. Anyway, Cell shaded? Yeah, people.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I saw a really cool
Archer.
Archer. Yeah.
Yeah, that was going around, but before that, I was looking and like, there's Borderlands cosplay.
Yeah,
yeah, there's some really cool
people that go as real life cell shaded. Mm-hmm. I'm just like, I want to learn how to do that.
Yeah, that'd be cool. You'd be good as that.
Have you ever been.
We saw some cool. We've seen the same dude. He was dressed as Solid Snake at Comic Con. I think we might have seen him at Supernova as well. Looked spitting image of you.
Yeah.
What were you saying?
What? I want to. I went on it a bit when I was in Traralgon because I wanted to start doing shit, but I didn't have a job, so I didn't have money.
Yeah.
Thing. I don't know how you say it. 501 Battalion. 501st.
The Star Wars thing.
It's like Star Wars, but like it's a bunch of.
It's a real like strict group of Star Wars cosplayers.
It's Star Wars, but I think they pretty much do any kind of battle
they
armor.
They do like other stuff too.
I went on there ages ago when I worked for the Good Friday Appeal. I saw some guy. It was weird. I was walking along. I was doing cash in transit, and I'm like, I'm surprised I haven't seen anyone in Star Wars shit. And then as soon as I like thought that, I walk around the corner. There's three people dressed as stormtroopers, and I'm like. Wonder if that's them, like the 501st or whatever the fuck. And then I walk around the corner and then two guys are walking and they've got these fully like, I don't know if it was merch or if it was like just everyone in the group has them or some shit, but had shirts like 501st Battalion.
Oh, I was
like,
that's cool.
No, I think they're dedicated just to Stormtrooper, like Star Wars stuff.
Oh, okay. Because I used to go on like a few for a few months and I know that was one of the major ones. So it was either related or, I don't know.
Yeah, I imagine maybe there's like a crossover.
Yeah, that's neat.
Because I was looking at all the Halo armors and shit, but some of the guns people make is just fucking crazy. Like, some of the modelers, it's like they make it out of wood and styrofoam and this and that, but then it's all painted and it just looks like the...
Oh, there's the UNSC 405th Infantry, which is like the Halo version.
Yeah, that'll be the Halo one.
Yeah, there's... What's his... Adam Savage from Mythbusters?
Yes.
Yeah.
He's got this...
Yeah, he likes doing
he's
that.
He's crazy, right? He's got this whole video of... Like, he's got all these videos about, like... The effort he puts into not just like doing costumes, but he's really crazy about like film props. And if he can't afford to buy one or if he can't source a film prop, he'll make like a replica of it.
That's really cool.
And he has all the detail. He goes into like all the stuff for the replicas he makes.
He did all the special effects work and shit, didn't he?
Yeah.
So he talks about like the replicas that they like when they sell like official replicas and just kind of how shoddy they are.
Yeah.
And like they're just kind of like die cast. They just take a mold of it and just paint it or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But like for Han Solo's blaster, he went all like that was based off like a German infantry pistol.
Mm.
So he like tracked that down
and modified that.
Built it up the way they built it up to make the prop.
That's really cool.
And like shit like one specific little like rubber stopper was from an aeroplane model kit in like the 1950s and shit
Holy
that he did track down and stuff.
That's really cool.
There's like all these communities dedicated to it.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That's like, really cool.
So yeah, some of the weapons for Halo and shit, they weren't just like solid ones. People actually made like mag ejectors and like the slides and shit actually function. Mm-hmm. Is that what the fuck? And like,
that's really cool.
There was that thing going around and someone made a mess. Like individual hand built needler models.
Oh shit. You mentioned this before.
Yeah, it's $600 and the whole thing has LED works through it as well, so it lights up. All the needles, there's about 20 in like the front of it that stick out, and they're all individually molded and like casted and shit. There's like a fucking shit ton of parts for the actual base that is put all together and they've just made it themselves. It's like, what the fuck?
Yeah, that stuff's so cool. Like, that's what I mean. Like the cosplays that are a bit shitty, but like God bless them, they're trying.
Yeah.
Are like fun to look at. And then the ones that just go like the extra super mile level are just like, shitty. Oh my god.
If it's like a super level of shitty, they're funny, like cardboard
that,
ones.
Yeah, that trashy Avengers one.
What was that?
Where like...
Oh, the shitty Avengers trailer?
You seen that?
No, it's just a
really dodgy Iceman costume.
No.
It's amazing.
I'll show this shitty Avengers cosplay, which is like, Hulk is just a dude in like one of those green morph suits.
Yeah, oh my god.
And like the rest are just in like empty beer slab cases. Yeah. Kind of like some badly painted and some not even.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
When it's like over the top fucking stuff. Yeah, they know exactly what they're doing.
Yeah. Oh, if it's intentionally
face,
bad.
Hulk's
then,
face is like burnt into my memory.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the little eyeballs.
Wait, show me again. I saw a fraction of a second with about 10 minutes worth of information to take in. His hammer is just a slab coated in foil.
Let me show you. Let me.
Thor looks drunk as fuck. He looks like he's been hit in the face.
Well,
with
I think
brick.
They had to drink all those beers to get him.
So, from the listeners, we got a couple of things. Caitlin, Lucas specifically. Caitlin said there was an interesting article on. On IFLS, I was wondering what that was. I fucking love science.
Yeah.
I fucking love science.
The only thing I like that I fucking love science does.
Yeah.
Is she, sometimes she'll go through and read all the hate mail she gets for just posting like science.
Yeah. Like, well, that's pretty much what this is. So it turns out that all these world's oldest bacterial fossils were actually just interesting mineral shapes. So now there are a whole bunch of creationists jumping in to say that it proves you can't trust science and shit. And a bunch of science enthusiasts jumping in like, at least we own our own fucking ignorance. And it's a hilarious shitstorm, apparently. There's some examples here. People saying, screw you, science, lol. Screw ooh, science, lol.
Oh my
spelled
God.
U with a U.
Well, I had this discussion, like, not discussion, really, because when it comes to this kind of thing, I just kind of smile and nod. My coworker was talking about, like, aliens, ancient aliens, like, starting the human civilization.
Fuck, my dad has had to deal with that shit
in
our class.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's
like,
enlightened, motherfuckers.
Like, okay, dude, sure, I'm just kind of in the camp of I'll believe it when I see it. Yeah. So, like, if aliens come down and, like, storm the planet, then absolutely, I'll phone you up and be like... You'll never guess what's happening.
Yeah, it's great. Yeah, you were right.
But until that point, I told you so.
I don't particularly care.
Yeah. I think, like, I mean, all the comments here are just people just being, like, saying, yeah, well, fucking time to admit global warming's bullshit as well, lol. now we can ignore this global warming nonsense.
We can be done with this global nonsense pageantry and we can get back to serious
this
business.
This man called John Flynn says...
We don't have enough shovels to bury all our heads in the sand.
I think he was supposed to say denying, but he's written, I was dying this shit in geology class all along.
Oh my
no
God.
No one wanted to hear it.
Ooh, ass
geology fractures. I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. But, bunch of people getting pissed off. This person says, the worst thing about science is scientists, in giant air quotes, believe nothing is possible until they say prove it is. Yeah, that's kind of science.
That's the point of science.
I think that's what shit's...
I hate about science is peer review and the scientific method.
Yeah, that's what shits me about people being like, oh, we fucking can't trust it because one day it's this, next day it's this. It's like, well, yeah, that's what's cool about science is that we can be wrong and, you know, correct shit and we're always working on stuff.
Yeah, if something's wrong, we change it. We don't make up things to
they
justify.
They can be wrong. I can watch them be wrong.
As a member of the scientific
community. I was saying to someone recently, like, I was thinking the other day, like, there's so much shit that I personally don't get how it works, and I'll sometimes see shit that freaks me out.
Sex.
Because I don't understand how it works, but knowing that there's someone way smarter than me out there who knows exactly how this works makes me feel so much better.
I don't think anyone knows exactly. What are you talking about?
Sick. Like, if I see some kind of weird, like, light thing that looks kind of supernatural.
It's a lamp.
Yeah, it might be a lamp.
If I see some kind of weird light thing, like a light.
Yeah. No, like, if I see, like, something kind of weird that I just, I've never seen before and I can't explain it. There's probably some dude in a lab somewhere who's like, I know exactly how that happens.
Yeah, it's just Pluto for attraction of light. I feel so stupid.
Yeah, exactly.
Look out, Radio Man.
I like kissing smart guys. But I don't know, that comforts me.
So you said you're like kissing smart guys.
Yeah.
I just assumed. Yeah, okay, cool.
So, yeah, I don't know. You guys got anything to add to that?
Do you know any weird, like, conspiracy just, types, I mean, guy?
Yeah, science shit. Like, just, yeah, because this doesn't, we don't have to talk about this specifically. Just,
you know,
weird
some,
science
shit. You
know, shit,
some, like, conspiracy nuts.
Shit.
I only know one.
You know one in particular.
We know one, yeah.
I don't really listen.
No, neither do I. I kind of tune out.
I try to switch.
I come back in occasionally to make, like, sarcastic comments.
I couldn't tell you what he was talking about. I honestly can't remember. I'm just
deaf camps, apparently. And I said, I've never been to camp. Sounds fun.
Like, no, that makes it sound cool because death is, like, dark and edgy.
Yeah, exactly. Well, he was saying that the world, we're all going to be in death camps eventually.
But no, that's
again,
true.
It's the sort of thing I'm kind of, when people say shit like that and they're like, oh, you'll be sorry. I'm just like, you know what, I probably will, but until then, I'm going to watch Daredevil.
You're not Daredevil, I don't care.
But yeah, I don't know, you got anything else to add to that? Or just going to look at, you're just going to look at funny Avengers pictures? God.
Yes.
It's got the googly eyes stuck to the morph suit head.
This, like, I try not to talk to this stuff about customers because they always bring
Talk about this stuff to customers. I was just checking. Sit the fuck down.
Yeah. I try not to talk about this stuff to customers.
Yeah.
Because
customers to stuff.
I'll take sort of the rational, sensible side, and they always make it seem like it's my fault now. So this guy's like, oh, yeah, you're still doing plastic bags? I'm like, yeah, we still got plastic bags. Well, because they're getting rid of them. And then, well, this is supposed to be a good thing, but what am I supposed to do? Where am I supposed to put my... When I'm cooking and I'm chopping up veggies, I like to put the rubbish in a plastic bag. Well, what am I supposed to do if they get rid of them? I'm like, I don't know.
Tell them not
to, like,
be so worried.
It's not good for the environment if I have to buy a whole bin bag for my choppings. It's like, okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
I was like, okay, well, no. You know, the plastic bags aren't biodegradable and the cotton, the fabric bags that they are. He's like, yeah, but you know how they make cotton with the sheep and all the chemicals they use? I was like, no, I don't. He's like, well, I used to be a sheep farmer. I'm like,
oh, cool. I used to be a sheep shagger.
And it's like, cool, I'm sure your experience like 20 years ago is still relevant today. Yeah. But, like,
you're
literally...
You know they're getting rid of those. Can we get rid of this fucking global warming bullshit as well? It's ridiculous. I never had, like, any of those kind of debates with customers at a video store. Never came up. Yeah, we had one guy.
I'll tell you my story because it's better than yours.
Yeah, it probably is.
No, this guy comes to the counter and he's got, like, we do PayWave, but it's not PayWave. Like, he takes his card out and honestly, he just, like, slaps it and then moves it back as fast as possible on the thing. I'm like,
oh, the radiation's gonna get.
He's just like, no, he's like waving it across. I was like, oh, dude. So the waving motion isn't really necessary, dude. He's like, well, it works on my machine at work. I was like, okay. He's like, whoa. I was like, something wrong with your machine. I was like, can I try? And I take his card and I just place it on the thing. And lo and behold, it's like, there you go.
Yeah.
And it just stomps off.
What a fucking
idiot. But at that point, you've already paid for it. So it's like, what are you going to do?
Yeah, exactly. The only like kind of weird conversation.
As soon as someone gives me their money, I was like, yeah, you fucked. Spitting all their drinks. You can't do that. What are you going to do? Well...
Drink something else. Drink water.
Still
no. I didn't think so.
Actually,
open your mouth.
I had one.
Actually, like...
I had one guy who was, like, an ex-spy, and he was in the highest... Like, he was privy to the highest in... Like, what? He was privy to the highest information.
Really?
And also he had a lobotomy because he knew too much, and he saw aliens, and
someone told you?
Yeah, first-hand experience.
Yeah. I've had a guy like this.
That was my first day of work for the doll. I didn't turn up ever again. I'm like, well, I came here to work.
Was that like your boss that was telling you that?
No, it was the guy that was working with me. I'm like, what they do then? And he was like that. I'm like, oh yeah, what they do then? And he was like, you just kept going and going and going. I'm like, well.
Yeah, like this guy.
This isn't the work environment I think I'm going to be a part for, and this experience is not like going to be relatable for me.
This guy used to come in my work though, just like prolific liar.
Yeah.
And it started off like kind of simple. We were just kind of like standing at the counter. He walks up. He's like, the radio is playing. He's like, do you know who this is? I'm like, yeah, it's Queen. He's like, yeah, it's Queen. Shame about Freddie Mercury though, isn't it? It was a real tragedy. I was like, yeah, it's pretty sad. He's like, I met him once. I saw him play. I met them afterwards. He was a nice guy. I was like, oh, cool. Conceivably that could have happened, yeah, I suppose.
Yeah, why not?
And then he talked about how he was in the, he was flying planes in the Navy.
Yeah.
I don't know if they flew planes in the Navy or not. Oh, they do, yeah.
Yeah.
Because the world's largest air force is a US Air Force.
Yeah.
And the second largest is a US Navy. That's how many planes they have.
Mm-hmm.
Fun fact. So he's like, yeah, I had an accident when I was working. I was like...
Oh, he pissed himself.
I was
I pissed and shit in the cockpit.
I was top ranks of the Air Force, but I was in an accident and now they just deny I was ever in there. And I was like, all right.
Don't bother looking it up.
Yeah, don't bother looking it up because you won't find evidence. Soldiers. And they didn't turn up for weeks. And then he came back in and like he's like, yeah, I haven't been around because I was in a car accident, paralyzed from the neck down.
What the
got better?
But I got better. I was like, oh, really? He's like, yeah, I've got x-rays if you want to see them. I was like, no.
He said yes.
Yeah.
And he
yeah.
would come in with his I'll Crayola examine. X-rays.
Baby's first x-ray.
Yeah.
It's like, this x-ray shows that you have breasts. So, and... a functioning vagina. Yeah, well, I was experimented on in the Navy, wasn't I?
Don't look it up,
to make me some sort of penisless freak.
Would you like
a woman?
Would you like, called it. Would you like to go out sometime?
I see
that's a working
sir,
vagina.
Sir, come on to this x-ray. You have a working vagina. It's like, yeah. What are you doing later?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to be hanging out with Freddie Mercury.
Would you like...
And John Lennon.
Elvis.
Would you like...
Is John Lennon still alive?
No.
Paul McCartney's dead. Mm. Paul McCartney's still alive.
No, he's dead. He's still dead.
Alive.
What about Ringo? Who cares?
secret mission in my...
I don't think bedroom. I ever... I in terms of like weird conversations or like conspiracy theorists or whatever,
right,
the only shit I ever had was, I've talked about it on here before, like the witch lady.
Yeah, I had a witch lady come into my work too and I texted you to find out if it was the same one, but it wasn't.
Different one.
So I was just like, she was like, I can't remember what she said, but she's mentioned she's like been at work all day. So I was just like, oh, what do you do? She's like, oh, I run a market stall. I was like, oh, that's interesting. What do you sell? She's like, well, crystals, healing, all sorts of healing crystals. I was like, oh, do they let you sell healing crystals at Vic Market? She's like, no, it was at the crystal market. Like, of course it was at the crystal market.
Did you ask if there was meth?
Crystal meth at the crystal market?
Did you tell her
the most healing strong?
You needed weaker
potions. Other than that, there was this dude, this Greek dude with his family would come in and they'd always try and get the old Chinese yogurt. Dude I worked for, some yogurt. No, they'd try and get him
Greek yogurt.
Well, no, converted to Greek Orthodox maybe. They'd always like be like, oh man, you know, come to our church sometime, man. There's always room for you. And Yo would be like, oh, lol, no.
That's exactly
but
what
they'd always
said.
End up having like these like theological debates with each other, and Yo was just kind of like, I don't really care.
You just keep passing farts.
I occasionally would chime in, but not with anything good.
If God's real, then explain videos.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh shit, we'll be back.
If he was a just loving God, would he give a man a body like this and take off all your clothes? Look! Behold!
Look upon his mistake!
Behold.
His greatest mistake!
Darwin. I am your Messiah now! Repent!
When I am able to hold God accountable for this, I will believe!
Behold,
Lord
Charles
Darwin. He has no mercy! There is only I, my saggy titties, and my freakishly large ball.
Ball.
Singular.
Ball. No, he'd be like, oh, you got to have faith. And I'm like, people are right. Faith in people. Yeah. He's like, oh, what about all the bad stuff? I'm like, what about all the doctors and shit?
We got police. Stops the bad people.
Yeah. What about all the cool...
God did make the police.
What about all the cool secret agents that stop
Tony
all the bad
Hawk?
Spies? What about Tony Hawk?
Yeah.
What the fuck about Tony Hawk?
Right?
You piece of shit.
If,
right.
if we're all made in God's image, why are there white people and black people?
So, Caitlin, thanks for sending that.
Ever
in.
Seen
that's
God
in.
Do a 720 Ollie flip?
Exactly.
No, I think so.
No, a 360
yeah,
in 360. Competition tournament.
Yeah.
Tony Hawk was the first person to do that.
Yeah.
No, wasn't it 720?
I thought it was 360.
I don't know. It was like...
360's normal.
You could yeah. If you did that trick in like Tony Hawk's Underground, you got like an achievement kind of thing for
what?
It.
360 or 720.
Or like whatever the trick
or
was.
Or 1080.
The trick that he pulled off that nobody else did.
I watched someone do like a crazy trick on a
4K.
On a on a skateboard, I think.
Yeah.
And they come down, and then like as they land the trick, they touch the ground afterwards, and I was like, "Oh, that's bullshit." I was like, "Wait, no, I couldn't do one of them.
Yeah. I can't move on a skateboard." So thanks for sending us that.
I used to be able to skate on my ass really well.
Yeah, really? Oh, yeah, me too. Thanks for sending us that, Caitlin. That's our 2 cents on creations.
I like when Tony Hawk pops up in movies and stuff. Like,
whoa, kids!
That's Tony Hawk, but he looks so old and he's so lame looking. He's not like a cool skater, like Bam Margera or something.
Yeah, but Tony Hawk's always been kind of a nerdy, lanky looking dude.
It's like, oh, cool, some dude's dad is here.
Yeah, he's like, hey, kids,
you're gotten so much.
You're wearing a helmet.
And yeah, like, for walking around, skating with his baby. I think.
Yes, no, yeah, skating with his daughter without a helmet, and then he replied.
How old was the daughter?
It was like a young kid, but like he's holding like her hand while on the skateboard, and he replied like, "I can skate better than most you can walk."
And so I mean, real life.
Someone went to reply, like, but they fell while tweeting.
Died.
Yeah, and they died, and he was like, "What up?" And then he ollied their grave.
And they were like,
900.
They're like, "Does anybody want to say anything about John Savage, Trump, who's dead, who died falling over trying to tweet?"
Yeah,
Tony Hawk. And Tony Hawk, yeah, he does like an ollie.
He was like, "If anyone,"
and he screams, "Tubular."
Yeah, he was like, "This
is that surfing time."
I don't know.
He'd flip, do a kickflip over his gravestone and said, "Surf's up."
Yeah, the priest was there. And like, if anyone,
tells him not to have a cow.
No, I'm gonna commit this man to the grave. And if anyone has any objections, out of them now, or forever hold your peace. And Tony Hawk burst out of the grave. A big sign.
They burst out of the coffin, next holding the dead man.
Yeah, doing flips. Kickflips with the.
I'm gonna be the first man to do a kickflip holding a corpse.
The man had rigor mortis, so he kickflipped the body.
Nice.
Everyone was like, awesome.
Took the wheels off his skateboard and put them onto the guy.
Everyone said Ganali, and the G is silent, but it was just so Ganali you had to say G.
The first G is silent, but the second one is it's G Ganali.
G Ganali.
It's G G. And a third G.
It was like that's
and then Ganali.
Yeah, it was like that's Ganali is a pterodactyl with pneumonia.
Pneumonia.
We have one more topic from Lucas Andrew. Ooh. Says movie or album or band or comic or video game that you really did not like at all to begin with, but eventually came around on. So something that grew on you in a big way.
You?
He's not a comic nor movie.
The first season of Community was trash.
Yeah, Community kind of grew on me. That was really shit. The first season Community I really didn't enjoy.
Yeah, I watch it back now and I like it because I like the characters.
Yeah. There's another show that's kind of like that like the first season was kind of shit.
Always Sunny wasn't great for the first season, to be honest.
No, but Always Sunny, I feel like the first season of Always Sunny, the first two seasons of Always Sunny, you had nothing to compare it to.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
you watch it now and it's kind of like, oh, this is a bit tame. But at the time, I thought it was like amazing and like lightning fast. But it's really slow compared to the latest, like season 3 onwards. But that's not something like I liked from the get go. I'm trying to think of like movies or albums or video games.
Yeah, there was something. I can't remember. It was a TV series, but I can't remember what it was.
Yeah, we'll think about this.
I didn't like it. Then someone sat down and watched it. I was like,
Veronica Mars.
No, I've always liked
that. Veronica Mars is great. He's got a new series out that I don't like at the moment, actually.
What's that?
Rob Thomas, I think the guy that created Veronica Mars.
Oh, okay.
It's an adaptation of the Vertigo comic I, Zombie.
Oh, okay. I've read that one.
It's not great. Maybe it is
the
great.
The comic's not great or the...
No, I haven't read the comic. But the adaptation's like... I was just expecting more Veronica Mars, to be honest.
Ah, okay.
Because it's like a female...
Expecting or hoping?
Female main character that solves crimes.
Yeah.
And like has like a love life, but there's no like real mystery overarching like Veronica Mars had. The first two seasons were amazing; like they had a real concrete story to them.
What happened? What was the other thing with Veronica Mars?
There was like
there was the rape thing.
Yeah,
was there something else? I can't remember.
Yeah, there was. There was the murder as well.
That's right. Yeah, yeah.
That was really cool.
The only comparable thing I have to that would be like Domino's Pizza.
Yeah, yeah, you've told that
fucking
story.
Yeah, but I've already told that. I can't really... I'm certain there was a show, but I can't remember what the fuck it was. It was, like, real-life sitcom.
Oh, Metalocalypse and Venture Brothers. I didn't like either of those until, like, I sat down and watched them myself.
It might have been, because it might have been Adult Swim, actually.
Yeah, because I always seem
a lot of Adult Swim stuff rubbed me out the wrong way.
Well, because I'd watch, like, one or two episodes out of sync when I came around here.
Oh,
and
yeah.
It's always been like that. The same few episodes.
Especially Venture Brothers, like you have to watch that in order.
When I first went down to Traugan, you guys were watching Venture Brothers, so I just slept on Jamie's couch.
Yeah. Jamie's couch in my house. Oh, no, wait, no, it wasn't Jamie's house.
Yeah, it was Jamie's house.
No, Jamie wasn't mine so much.
I slept down his stairs.
That's right, you did.
Yeah.
No, I remember because I showed you Venture Brothers.
Yeah, Metal Apocalypse I had no interest in because
you don't, like metal. And you don't like the apocalypse.
But the comedy is like...
Yeah, the comedy is way better.
Like in terms of TV shows and stuff, I can't really think of anything or movies or, you know...
Parks and Recreation as well. I'm not even sure
Parks
I like
and
that.
Parks and Rec I don't really like, to be honest. I don't like it.
Which
seasons did you watch?
Yeah, I watched some of what you were watching with Jamie. I think that was season 5.
I didn't mind. I actually don't mind Parks and Rec.
I watched it so much that like I like the characters now and I can all laugh at the jokes and stuff. And the last season was genuinely really good because they for some reason they just shoehorned John Hamm in Don Draper from Mad Men as just this like really obnoxiously stupid guy.
Yeah.
So like they send him off to find a file on like the taking over the town or whatever, and he comes back. He's like, oh, I couldn't find that. I found this folder. Oh, it's called Bird Census. It's empty. I will be at Subway if anyone wants to hang.
Like there was some. I was watching it with Guy and Jamie and Caitlin here. Like one time when we were just chilling, and Jamie was down, and like. There were some lines that got me, and then, but like for every line that made me go, ah, that's funny, there was about 3 or 4 that kind of annoyed me.
I don't watch it.
I watch it for Chris Pratt and for Ron Swanson.
Oh, it's Chris.
Yeah, Pratt. Chris Pratt, Ron Swanson, and I've forgotten the guy's name. The dude,
Adam Scott.
No. Oh, shit.
Aziz Ansari.
No, I don't really like Aziz Ansari.
Yeah, I don't like him.
I watched a movie live stand up. Is he the dude who's always like really happy and like?
Yeah.
What's his name again? The character,
Jerry Gergich.
Not the character. Sorry, the actor. Rob Lowe.
Rob Lowe. Yeah. Really Jerry's the fat, like incompetent one.
Oh no, not Jerry. Rob Lowe.
I think his name's actually Terry, but like they called him Jerry by accident on his first day, and he just never corrected them.
Yeah, that's the fat guy, isn't it?
And then he went around to being like Larry. Because again, they messed up, and then the very last season, they accidentally call him Terry instead of Larry, and that's his real name. So he's like, "Yes." I think he had a heart attack, but farted, so everyone just laughed instead.
Yeah, he kept like farting. They're like trying to help him, and, like he's passing out on the like next to the door, and he's like, "Oh!" And it's like, "Oh my god, are you?" And it's just like so many stock sounds.
Yeah, that's right. He has like a heart attack, but farts. So they all. So Aziz Ansari's like, "Wait." Yeah, the fart attack.
He kept trying to make the doctor say that he had a fart attack. And he's like, so what's the medical term for someone that has a heart attack and then is closely followed by Fletcher? That would still be
Donna,
a heart attack.
I find her obnoxious.
Who's Donna?
The black one.
I don't know. I didn't, nothing to say about that.
I didn't really like the show to begin with. And then, I don't know, I think I like it more.
I don't like Leslie that much.
No, then you're beyond hope, I think.
Like, as with you, it's like a few lines, like, make me laugh here and there, but I think I'm conditioned to like it thanks to Tim and Eric, because after anything fucking stupid happens, it's just a down barrel, like, the fuck
that,
is
see,
happening?
That annoys me, like, a little bit. It feels like they're overusing that.
Yeah, that just made me laugh, because I was really tired, and I'm conditioned from Tim and Eric.
Yeah, no, fair enough. Like, again, there's some bit lines in there that make me giggle, and if I spend enough time with the characters, I might actually get
Season 1, they establish them as making this, like, documentary about the Parks and Rec
service.
And then
the doco thing goes way out.
Never mention it again, but they still do, like, the mockumentary where they look at the camera and stuff. And I expected the last episode of them to be like, all right, that's probably enough footage or something.
Yeah.
Nothing. They finished the whole series without mentioning.
Have they finished it?
Yeah, finished.
Oh.
Okay. How I Met Your Mother was one that I really didn't like the first season, and then the second season onwards, I thought it got better up until maybe season 4 or 5.
Yeah, and then I
stopped watching. I don't know where that went.
I think
and then when I went back, the weird thing is that's one that I warmed up to a lot, to the point where I really liked that show and it made me laugh a lot. And then I went cold on it, and now when I try to go back and watch it, I'm so cold on it that every joke, every like, because that show's got a laugh track, right?
Yeah.
Every time the laugh track kicks in, I just feel angry.
I think for me, I realized at one point, I told this before when I was talking about like I like The Wedge. Then one of the teachers was like, Mr. Glennie was like, oh, I like shows that are funny.
Yeah.
I watched back and I was like, do I actually like this? And like, listen to it. And I'm like, no, I'm just laughing because there's a laugh track.
Yeah.
I don't actually like the show. I'm like, what the fuck?
I don't know.
Like, that was really weird for me. It just made me stop and think. And then I'm like, anything with a laugh track, I'm normally just like,
It rubs me up the wrong way with shows that aren't funny that have a laugh track. Like, Seinfeld has a laugh track because it was mostly shot in front of a live studio. It's literally like
saying hold for applause.
Yeah, something. Yeah. But well, like it's Seinfeld, like, no, Seinfeld had a
staring down the barrel at your audience. Like, hey, listen up. You're too stupid to know when the funny bits are on, so we'll just tell you.
These jokes aren't funny, but they put a fucking laugh track in. It annoys me. Mm.
If you don't notice the laugh track, then it's good.
Yeah,
but if you
most things that have a live laugh track are shot in front of a live studio audience.
Really? Yeah. I thought like Big Bang Theory and stuff.
Big Bang Theory is shot in front of a live audience.
Well, that is a stupid fucking audience. Like,
no, fuck. God, what was damn. It? Was it?
Oh. Big Bang Theory, you can watch those edits where they just take out the laugh track.
Having to
watch that beat where they just kind of pause in between jokes is really a weird thing.
They have
to kind of write that into the script, I guess.
Yeah. One of the really common ones had the same laugh track, and I got pointed. I was listening to something. It might have been...
Sleeping Cast, we're talking about it.
It was Sleeping Cast then, yeah, because they had the one guy that had the eccentric laugh, and so it stood out every time they played that.
I never needed to warm up to Fresh Prince, though. I love Fresh Prince.
Yeah, Fresh Prince, I pretty much... Fresh Prince I warmed up to a little bit, but I was pretty much on board.
Fresh Prince was just Seinfeld, always on TV.
Seinfeld is fantastic. Like,
really? No, the first season I'm not fond of.
But again, it's the sort of thing that, like, that the first season is good when you don't have the rest of the show to compare it to.
Oh, wait, no, Digimon. Digimon, actually.
Digimon you warmed up to?
No, because when I was a kid, I was like a fucking Pokemon Nazi. I'm like, this is like clearly a fucking
You're
Pokemon
so, group. Like... You're, like, dedicated to one thing.
Yeah.
You'll pick something and really just, like...
I'm smart.
This is
I'm
my
loyal.
Opinion on this, and I refuse to see anything else.
Well, yeah, that's because I'm.
Well, no, I think you're
stubborn. Stubborn
I think,
is the word.
But I think you'll not be like, I like this and this thing's shit. You're just like, I like this, and I'm not going to give this other thing a chance because why I've got this thing already.
Pretty much. Yeah, I had a Digimon, and then eventually we got Fox Kids.
Yeah,
because Foxtel at some point, like Fox Kids, wasn't part of the basic package, even though it's. Oh no, it's weird, even though it's called Fox.
Well, like, no, I think that's like,
it's fucking bizarre, but eventually that became part of the staple package, and I watched some of that, and I was like, oh, this isn't bad.
Mm-hmm.
I remember at one point, my child logic of like six, literally one thought that occurred to me, how do they keep them? They don't have Pokeballs. I remember that as a thought.
How do they stop them from leaving them?
Yeah, I literally,
like, everybody leaves me.
Yeah, because I just
saw... friends.
I just saw, it's like, it's kids with these monsters that fight each other. It's obviously Pokemon.
I can't think of any movies or like other TV shows or anything other than probably How I Met Your Mother is probably the best example.
There's movies that I watched once and I was kind of like,
Shoot 'em up. First time I watched that, I didn't like it very much.
Brick, the first time I watched it.
Yep.
What?
Brick.
What is Brick?
It's like a neo noir detective movie with Joseph Gordon Levitt. And it's like, because they talk so fast and the way they talk is really quirky. So it took me a while to sort of watch it and get what they were saying.
It's cool though.
Yeah.
We've got to go to Albuquerque.
You're some peaches, Georgia peaches. There are a lot of bands that I've like heard first and been just kind of like, oh, what the fuck?
Oh, yeah, I didn't like
I'm still waiting for that to happen with Sign Our Teeth. I'm like, I'm gonna like it eventually.
Yeah, I didn't like metal at first. I was like, what the fuck are they saying? And I didn't like, I always hated...
As a kid, like, I'd say, I don't like it because they're just screaming, a bunch of girls fucking yelling about whatever. But it was genuinely, I didn't like it because it scared me.
Oh. Ham on pizza.
Yeah? You warmed up to ham on pizza?
No, he the last couple of years.
Wow.
He'd say that ham on pizza is what girls have.
Because shredded ham.
Scared of ham on pizza.
Shredded ham is like worms.
A lot of the bands that I didn't like initially, I warmed up to eventually when I kind of stopped doing the whole like metal elitist thing and like, it's got to be really heavy or if it's got clean singing then pop style singing, it's fucking shit. I hate it. So I really didn't like A Day to Remember the first time I heard them. I was like, this is
ADTR.
Fucking, I was like, this is a fucking... pussy bullshit.
What about Slipknot?
Slipknot I immediately loved.
Are you a maggot?
Almost to spite people, because I heard some of the like kind of the footy kids talking about music. Yeah. I was like, it was in like a spare class where the teacher hadn't shown up, so we were waiting for the substitute and we're sitting there and I was like listening to my iPod and I think I was listening to like Fall Out Boy or something. And they're like, oh, what are you listening to? I'm like, oh, Fall Out Boy. And they're like, yeah, that's all right. And this one of the kids was like to the other one, oh, you like what are you like metal, like Slipknot? And the guy's like, oh, no, I hate Slipknot. Fucking weird. I don't get it. It's fucking weird and I hate it. And I immediately like went home that night and like downloaded a bunch of Slipknot shit on LimeWire and was like, this is perfect. I love it.
I'm going to be a maggot now.
Yeah.
I used to hate, when I was a kid, I used to hate rap and metal.
Yeah.
You still do?
No.
You threatened to... drive into like traffic lamps.
Yeah, and I ripped out my stereo when Connor played rap.
You literally ripped your stereo out as a joke when Connor was playing rap.
I thought you said joke.
joke. No, sorry, as a serious statement.
In anger, yeah. No, yeah. Like, back then it was, I have no idea what the fuck they are saying. And now it's like, metal, it's okay, because now I actually, like, I have an ear for it and I can understand what they're saying.
Yeah.
Like, if I haven't heard a song and someone's, like, screaming some shit, I can actually make out, like, a decent portion of the words, but back then, it was just noise to me.
Yeah.
And now I just don't like rap, because every time I hear it, it's always about getting bitches.
Beastie Boys.
Some rap, you didn't like Beastie Boys originally?
No, like, last couple of years, I just started listening to a lot of Beastie Boys.
Mm-hmm.
When MCA died?
Yeah.
I think, did MCA die?
Yeah.
I was like, I'll check this stuff out. And when they're on Futurama and stuff.
Yeah.
And because they again, sometimes it's hard to follow the lyrics.
Yeah.
But when you listen to them, they're pretty cool.
Oh, shit. There's some, like, I like some rap. I don't really like the stuff that's about getting bitches and stuff. Yeah. I like the stuff that's kind of similar to metal in the sense that it's like.
Yeah, if it's like.
It's about, yeah, like.
If it's heavier.
Doing, usually. Yeah, it's the beat's heavier and the feel's heavier. Yeah, or like if it's that kind of like those hip-hop groups like Wu-Tang Clan and like NWA and stuff where they're just singing about themselves and yeah. it's not usually about being cool guys. Yeah. I like listening to all this stuff
about like how hard it is growing up in the Bronx. I'm just like, yeah, man. Preach it.
Right?
I grew up
in Nidri, bro.
I was listening to Let's Drown Out and Gabriel really likes Wu-Tang Clan, I think.
Apparently
one of the lyrics had mentioned Voltron.
That's cool.
Well, they're all like.
Can we laugh really hard?
Fans, they're all like old time, like kung fu movie buffs and stuff.
Yeah.
That's why they get the name Wu-Tang Clan. So they always like mix clips.
That does sound like it.
They always mix like clips from kung fu movies into their songs.
I haven't listened to any of this.
Oh, you see my Wu-Tang style and shit like that.
Tiger style.
I don't know. I've definitely warmed to like some rap and a lot of pop music. In fact, like Taylor Swift, I really like.
I don't think anyone can hate T-Swizzle, though.
Some people do. Or some people just be like, oh, she's shit. Like, there's so many people who are like, oh, she's shit. All she does is sing about how she should have some guy instead of some other girl.
She does really smart songs about how, like, the media views her and her relationship with other men and stuff.
Yeah. But, I mean, even when she was just, like, she was 16 when she put out her first album, right? Like,
Jesus.
What the fuck else is a 16-year-old girl going to write about except, like, you know, romance and love and shit? And when, spaghetti. Like... What's his name? When John Mayer does the same fucking thing, every album's about fucking chicks, but it's not at like stated like that.
Yeah,
everyone's like, ooh, like he's
Michael,
a Casanova.
No one cares that Michael Bublé only sings about women.
Yeah, exactly. It's bullshit. But Taylor Swift I warmed up to completely.
I hate her now because she's not on Spotify.
A Day to Remember I still like, but that whole like metalcore genre, I gave it a chance and found stuff to like about it, but now I'm enjoying it a lot less now that like when metalcore seems to be, or the metalcore like A Day to Remember and stuff like that seems to be populated entirely by like jocks, basically.
So that
oh yeah,
it feels like a lot of the fans of that are the people who
that influences
don't
your
like,
opinion on the music.
No, I can still like the music, but I kind of
it does for
like
me.
Yeah, it influences a little bit.
Yeah, it's like it does
I,
for
I
me.
Hate
I'm
say,
like, do
I
hate
I
fully
to say it.
It
sounds really petty, but like
no, like you're allowed to enjoy what you want.
I mean, I still like if it comes on my iPod, I'll be like, yes.
Wrong at all, but like when I think of like metalcore bands and like the fan base, it's like a bunch of jocks and shit.
Mm.
I think a few years ago, all the guys that like are in metal bands remind me of the exact people that all the jocks would be like, oh, you're a faggot or a queer.
Well, that's the thing, exactly.
Is
I
that
feel
just,
like,
is that just
yeah,
me?
That's,
I don't
that,
really
no,
know
that's
many.
What kind of rubs me up the wrong way is the sort of people I see listening to A Day to Remember or whatever and being like, yeah, this is fucking heavy.
Yeah.
I dig this shit. Yeah, ooh, let's do some kicks. Are the same sort of people who would, call you a faggot for listening to Slipknot or some shit, you know? And I think that's what rubs me up the wrong way about that whole genre. But the music itself, like, when it's not like kind of like sounding like every like sounding identical to another 10 songs, it's good, it's enjoyable. So yeah, that's it in terms of like topics sent by other peeps. Yeah, thanks for that, Caitlin and Lucas. We got some good chats out of that.
Goodbye.
So we're seeing Avengers Age of Ultron sometime soon. We're aiming for not Thursday, the day it comes out, but Friday. And we'll hopefully have a spoiler cast up not long after that, similar to
Friday night, you have my solemn vow that Connor will have edited the podcast.
There we go, solemn vow from me.
Which will include special guest, Mr. Black.
Hopefully we'll have that up and be similar to the Guardians of the Galaxy one. I was thinking we should like
do more improv on the podcast. Yeah,
yeah. This is all scripted, too heavily scripted. No, we should do more spoiler casts. Even if they're not that long.
Yeah,
just like quick ones afterwards. Anyway,
you
doesn't matter.
Enough,
spoiler cast. It was rare good.
It was rare good. Thanks heaps for listening, ladies and gents.
He's been Connor. Talk to you next time.
I love you. Good night. Yeah, I've been Connor O'Keefe.
Ethan tried being Connor O'Keefe, but didn't enjoy it. And I, Guy Clark, was Connor O'Keefe, but then was found out and charged with identity fraud. Goodbye.
Goodbye, my lover.